Vanderbilt Commodores. By 1951, he had the Tennessee Volunteers on the way to a national championship, and his trademark was a strong defense, this block kick resulting in a Tennessee touchdown. That year, Tennessee won 35-27. By 1956, the Tennessee single-wing tailback was a young man named Johnny Majors, who is presently the head coach of the Vols. He finished as runner-up for the Heisman Trophy, runner-up to Paul Hornung. Tennessee won it 27-7. But last year, Whit Taylor was the quarterback for Vanderbilt, throwing touchdown passes all over the lot, and Vanderbilt was the victor last season by a score of 28-21. Today, 90,000 fans have gathered here to see a renewal of this series. Exciting college football on CBS Sports.
The University of Tennessee in Knoxville, Tennessee. It's the Vanderbilt Commodores versus the Tennessee Volunteers, sponsored by Chevrolet. America's on the move, and Chevrolet is supplying the wheels. Chevrolet and you taking charge. And by Sears, where you'll find great value. There's more for your life at Sears.
Here come the Vanderbilt Commodores. Their coach is George McIntyre. Here come the Tennessee Volunteers and Johnny Majors. I'm Lindsey Nelson with Scott Hunter. And Scott, we're here at Neyland Stadium. Despite the fact I went to school here, I've worked around this stadium for most of my life on one role or another. This is the first time I've ever been back here to do a live telecast.
Well, welcome to East Tennessee, you old mountain man.
Thank you very much. Scott Hunter, tell us about Vanderbilt.
Vanderbilt has two receivers, tops in the nation in pass receiving. You got Keith Edwards with 90 catches. You got Chuck Scott, their tight end, with something like 66 catches. They're going to be working over that Tennessee secondary today.
Tell me about the Tennessee defense.
Well, Tennessee has to counter with their great defensive tackle, one of the best who's ever wore the orange. Reggie White has 13 sacks this year. He's got to get on key to Kirk Page if they're going to stop those Commodores.
We have two outstanding coaches here today, so now let's check in and see what the coaches think about today's football game at Neyland Stadium.
Vanderbilt rivalry is a fierce one. Of course, it always is the last game of the season for both teams. We're inside the borders of Tennessee. We're both in the Southeastern Conference. And for us, it's always one of the most important football games we play year in and year out.
Regardless of what our season has done so far, the Tennessee game is always the game that we aim for. I think our youngsters will remember what happens today more than any other game they've ever played.
And so that just about sets it up. Vanderbilt and Tennessee, we'll be back with the opening kickoff in just a moment.
Chevrolet.
Game conditions. It's a beautiful afternoon here in East Tennessee. Temperature 62 degrees and the wind from the south at 10 miles per hour, and the forecast is sunny. Tennessee won the toss, waved it off, elected to take choice to start the second half. Vanderbilt then elected to receive. Juan Reves is kicked, teeing the ball up to kick it off for Tennessee. Reves, born in Bogota, Colombia, came to Knoxville from Miami, Florida, has kicked off 50 times this year. Only 15 have been returned. Clay Parker and Con Anderson are the deep men for Vanderbilt. Usually Reves gets it across the end line. The referee here this afternoon is Dick Burleson. In the air, taken 3 yards deep, will not be run out. It's going to be a touchback, first and 10 at the 20-yard line. Clay Parker elected not to run it out. Let's take a look at the offensive unit now for Vanderbilt University, the Commodores. Kurt Page is the quarterback, and he's a good one. Keith Edwards, tailback, and he's a good one. Stevenson starting at fullback. Ardell Fuller and Phil Roach are the wide receivers. There you see the line, and the tight end is Chuck Scott, who has caught 66 passes. We expect Witherspoon to be in the ballgame very shortly. Edwards and Stevenson are the running backs in there just now. That is Page waiting to get the snap.
Vanderbilt in a spread, Lindsey.
And a spread and a quarterback draw on the first play, and no gain. No gain on a quarterback draw, and Reggie White made the tackle. So let's take a look now at the defense of the Tennessee Volunteers.
Reggie White, you see, they're All-American candidate at left tackle. Middle guard Johnny Williams, Mark Studaway at right tackle. They'll have their hands full with this Commodore passing attack. Mackenzie Jones, you see the linebackers there.
Xander and Toles, the fine linebackers, and those are the deep men. Second down and 10 yards to go with the ball still at the 20-yard line. Page dropping back. Guns it and completes it up to the 25-yard line. And it was taken by Keith Edwards.
That is number 91 for him this year. Terry Brown made the tackle. It's at the 25-yard line.
We'll see that a lot today. Keith Edwards coming out of the backfield on a little halfback stop route between the linebackers, Page zotting it to him.
At the hash mark left, five receivers, Roach and Scott. Third down, 5 yards to go. Andy again going out into that spread formation. Page dropping back. And throws it complete across the 30 for the first down and on across the 35-yard line to Louis Stevenson. First and 10 for the Commodores of Vanderbilt at the 38-yard line.
We knew coming into this game that the coaches were going to throw things at each other that neither team had seen. This is exactly what Vanderbilt is doing to Tennessee, a spread formation causing Tennessee some problems with their coverage. That time they've got the tight end wide open on the drag route.
Linebacker Jim Duncan spent it across and made the tackle. Lone setback for the Vanderbilt Commodores on the first down, 10 yards to go at their own 38-yard line. Luck gets to leave this one on the ground. Louis Stevenson carried, and he was popped by Dale Jones from Cleveland, Tennessee. Right at the line of scrimmage, second down and 10 yards to go at the 38.
He's a freshman, but he hit him like Leroy Jordan, the other guy that wore that 54 down at Alabama a few years ago.
Charles Benton comes in there defensively now. Had a strong safety for Tennessee. Kirk Page, the quarterback. From Nashville, Tennessee, Father Ryan High School. Spread formation, wide receivers left and right. Page back again. Sends it over to the right side. Trying to get it to his favorite receiver, Keith Edwards. Keith Edwards right there, tiptoeing along the sideline, made the grab. And Benton was the defender.
Vanderbilt on second and 10, third and 10 is not concerned, especially second and 10, second and long. They're going to get the backs, the tight ends. They're going to get them out there for the 6 and 7, 8 yard gains, put themselves in third and fours, third and fives. There you see another example of it.
Third down and 5 yards to go. Ball's on the 43-yard line of Vanderbilt in their possession. No score of the game having just begun. Scott and Roach wide to either side. Option play and the handoff. Again, about a yard by Louis Stevenson, the fullback who got the handoff from Kirk Page on the ride. And that's going to bring up a fourth down. Jim Duncan again made the tackle for Tennessee. Punting unit comes onto the field for Vanderbilt. The punter is Ricky Anderson, junior from St. Petersburg, Florida, who has averaged 43.1. His longest punt of the year, 67. Tim McGee is dropped back to receive it, standing back at his own 13-yard line for Tennessee. Artificial turf here at Neyland Stadium. Anderson gets the snap, puts it up. McGee at the 19, hit right there. Good kick coverage and no return at all. Mark Wooler made the tackle. So the Tennessee Volunteers get the ball for the first time today at their own 18-yard line. Alan Cockrell is the quarterback. Johnny Jones, the tailback. Randall Mars at full. He'll play both tailback and fullback. Taylor and Duncan, wide receivers.
Those are good a pair right there, I'll tell you.
And the tight end is John Matthews, who has not caught a pass this year.
Let's see what he does today.
Alan Cockrell, the quarterback. Takes to the tailback, Jones. We got about four to the 22-yard line, and we should tell you that Johnny Jones, number 33 of Tennessee, needs 22 yards rushing to set a Tennessee rushing record for a single season, breaking the record held by a Haskell standback. There's the defensive line.
Steve Bearden there has been there. Good left end, defensive left end, a little hurt. And now back in good shape. You see the linebackers there. Carl Jordan, he's an excellent one. There you see the secondary, Leonard Coleman, an All-American candidate.
Bearden had a virus that had embedded for quite a while. He lost about 20 pounds during that time. Short drop for Cockrell.
It's up.
And it's gathered in. It's going to be a touchdown for Tim McGee. Tim McGee is all the way, and Tim McGee for Tennessee's in the end zone. Tom Moore was the defender. Gervais is under attempt at conversion. 23 of 24 points after. Dak Sells is holding. stretch. So with 11 minutes, 14 seconds left in the quarter, Tennessee leads 7-0.
Earlier when I saw Tennessee play Alabama, Alan Cockrell had two or three 80-yard type touchdowns. Here you see another one. It's a play-action fake. He had actually too much time to throw the ball. No pressure from the Vanderbilt defensive front. McGee runs a post split route down the middle. He's got it on the hash mark, 78 yards for the first Tennessee score.
So the Volunteers of Tennessee have gone out in front early in the ball game, and that is Smokey the mascot.
He's come home to Tennessee, and here's the man that taught him everything he knows, General Bob Nalen, the great Tennessee football coach, and the guy on the left, of course you know who that is.
Hey, that's a pretty good teacher. That picture was taken in 1951, and he is showing me that, in his opinion, the best place to run the football is off tackle right.
And he did enough of it, too, I'll tell
and
you.
And he did it well. The Volunteers have taken the lead here by a score of 7-0. Fouad Reveille will kick it off. His first kickoff was not returned. Clay Parker and Don Anderson are back there deep for Vanderbilt. Fouad Reveille had a 60-yard field goal last year against Georgia Tech to set a Southeastern Conference record. He has not had one over 50 this year. He's tried only two over 50 this season. High trajectory this time. Clay Parker waits. And he drops the ball in the end zone. Doesn't have to run it out. Doesn't have to run it. It's a touchback. It'll be put in play first and 10 at the 20-yard line. I think he was going to run it out. I think he had in mind maybe he was only a yard deep in there, and I think he had an idea of maybe running that one back. There's the scoring drive, and he consumed only 46 seconds, two plays, 78-yard pass. That'll take up most of a scoring drive.
Tennessee's got a big play offense. Cockrell had something like 257 yards in the first quarter against Alabama on three or four passes.
Kurt Page came into this game with a completion percentage of 57.6, 13 touchdowns, 27 interceptions. Running backs in an eye formation. Gives it to his tailback this time. Gets it out there to about the 23-yard line. Picked up about three.
Vanderbilt knows they need to establish something on the ground. They can't come out and throw the ball every down, hoping to just move it that way. They've got to establish something on the ground. Thus, you see him trying to run the ball on first.
Second down. 7 yards to go. Weatherspoon is in there now. Ken Weatherspoon, and Edwards has moved over. Weatherspoon, number 33, out of running back. Dropping back is Page. Incomplete. Keith Edwards, the man for whom it was intended. That'll make it 3rd and 7. Here are the total offense leaders in the country.
Kurt Page down there with averaging almost 200, a little over 270 yards. He's right out there with all of them. Doug Flutie, who you saw yesterday, you did the game, Alabama, yesterday. He had an excellent game against my old alma mater, the Crimson Tide.
3rd down and 7 yards to go at the 23. Edwards and Stevenson in the backfield now. Page. In and out, incomplete. Got it just into the hands of Louis Stevenson. But that'll make it 4th and 7. Bring the punting unit on now for Vanderbilt. Dale Jones was covering defensively, a linebacker.
George McIntyre told me that he would start Edwards, but would move Stevenson over at the halfback spot as quick as he could. You see a freshman right here, a young freshman. He sometimes goes out of his hands. This is what happens in those big games. You've got to get a little more salt and a little more experience.
Ricky Anderson back there in deep punt formation. McGee is deep to receive it for Tennessee, standing at his own 36-yard line. Wade Smith makes the snap from center. Good one. High spiraling kick. McGee moves over. He's got it at the 34, 35, 40. And he was nailed as he was heading for daylight at the 44-yard line. Tackle was made by Chuck DeGroote. It'll be 1st down and 10 yards to go for the Volunteers of Tennessee, who lead in the ballgame by a score of 7-0. 10 minutes, 13 seconds remaining to be played in the first quarter.
Conference already accepted a bid to the Sugar Bowl. I was at the Auburn-Georgia game. What a great football game it is. Alabama 4-1 with a chance to still beat Auburn and salvage something out of this season. Now you see Tennessee 3-2. Vanderbilt 0-5 this year. They had a good year last year, hoping to do better next year.
We should tell you that Tennessee tailback number 33, Johnny Jones, needs 132 yards to become the first Tennessee player to rush for 1,000 yards in a single season. He got four in the first series. He's got the ball now. But hauled out by a trailer, Bob O'Connor from Tacoma, Washington, 230-pound linebacker for Vanderbilt.
Johnny Jones, get ready.
Gain of only a yard on the play. It'll be second down and 9 yards to go.
Bob O'Connor, their leading tackler. He's their big play defensive man.
Last week, Johnny Jones against Kentucky rushed 31 times for 150 yards. They're giving him every shot to get to that 1,000-yard record. Now the faking Cockrell is doing, and he completes it. It's taken by Lenny Taylor from Miami, Florida, and he's down to the Vanderbilt 31-yard line.
Cockrell on the play-action fake to hold the linebackers. It does just exactly that. Look at the Vanderbilt linebackers flat-footed. Cockrell coming to his right. Taylor ran the little seam route. That's go out, find yourself in that zone seam, and just sit there and let Cockrell drop it over to you. Good throw. Nice mental route by Taylor.
Sam Henderson, tended fullback, 245-pound fullback from South Bend, Indiana, number 43. Instead, it goes to Johnny Jones. Johnny Jones picks up yardage down to the 24-yard line. Picked up about 7 on the play. It'll be second down and 3 yards to go. William Thomas and Bob O'Connor made the tackle for Vanderbilt.
Johnny Jones averaging almost 100 yards per game. He might kick it up some if he keeps carrying the ball like that.
Now a blocking fullback coming in, Kenneth Cooper from Huntsville, Alabama. Used primarily as a blocker.
Lee High School in Huntsville.
Lenny Taylor and Clyde Duncan are the wide receivers. Lenny Taylor, diving catch just outside the 10-yard line. Moore was covering Tom Moore. That'll be a first down and 10 yards to go. It's going to be spotted near the 12-yard line where his knee touches.
Yesterday I talked to Johnny Majors about Cockrell's throwing that slant in that seam area to the slot man. That's exactly what we just saw. Cockrell threw it right off the hip of the weak linebacker. He had no chance to react right into that dead spot to the slot receiver.
Henderson is back in there now and Cooper's out. First and 10 at the 12, full pivot, and the pitch to Jones, Johnny Jones. Well, he might have got a yard, about one down to the 11. Bob O'Connor made the hit for Vanderbilt. Second down and 9 yards to go at the 11. 8 minutes remaining to be played in the first quarter here at Neyland Stadium on the campus of the University of Tennessee in Knoxville. We can get some arguments back and forth about the pronunciation of that name, but I can tell you that the general, the major as he was when he came, he called it Neyland, K-N-E-E.
Whatever you say, Mr. Nelson.
Many who played for him called him Neyland, but they never talked to him directly. Talking back now. It's Cockrell. He lost it out there, and it's left to Jones, and Jones, the receiver, gets inside the 5-yard line. Steve Wade made the tackle. There's a penalty marker on the play.
Screen pass outside. Cockrell keeping his eyes downfield to freeze the linebackers and keep them downfield. Dropping the ball out to Jones on the semi-screen action. He never stops or sets up. That's why you call it a semi-screen. It worked, but Tennessee might be accused of blocking before he... There's clipping.
Clipping indicated by the referee, Dick Burleson.
That goes to show, as Jack Greaves and you have taught me, Lindsey, don't guess with the officials because they don't want to broadcast either.
We'll replay the down. All right, I'm from his flag. I'm going one over, 15 yards, okay? One.
That's going to be more than that. Two, you might have heard a little of the conversation saying it's 15 yards.
Clipping against the offense. Replay second down.
Clipping against the offense.
These are the things that have plagued Tennessee down inside the 20-yard line. Penalties, interceptions, busted assignments. Johnny Majors hopes not too many today.
Ball is at the 29-yard line.
Oh,
Jones. Johnny Jones gets down to the 17-yard line. Tom Moore made the stop there.
Tennessee coming right at that Vanderbilt defensive line. There you see power blocking. Watch that center. Watch that center. What a great block by him. Bill Mayo, Glenn Streno there. Johnny Jones sprung through. Tennessee knows they can move the ball on Vandy, so you'll see a lot of straight-on power blocking type plays today.
Third down. And long.
Audible.
Jones. Johnny Jones gets down to about the 7-yard line. That's not enough for the first down. So here comes Bob Reves on fourth down to attempt the first field goal of the day. He is 15 of 23. The yardage just picked up by Johnny Jones makes him the all-time single-season rusher, breaking the record set by Haskell Standback.
Haskell Standback played with him in Atlanta. Also, that puts Johnny Jones in quite some company with Majors and some of the rest.
25-yard field goal. Sells is holding for Reves. It is up and long, and it's good. Rod Reves with a 25-yarder adds three more points for the Volunteers. And so we have 5 minutes, 53 seconds left to play in the first quarter. And it is Tennessee 10 and Vanderbilt nothing. It'll be Tennessee kicking off now. For Rod Reves will boot it off from the 40-yard line and back deep to receive it for Vanderbilt. Clay Parker and Thon Anderson. Parker's 26, Anderson is 28. There they are in the end zone. Two previous kickoffs of Reves were not returned. One was 5 yards deep in the end zone. One was 1 yard deep in the end zone. Shadows have lengthened to include the entire playing surface here at Neyland Stadium. Dick Burleson indicates we're ready to go. To the Parker side and deep in the end zone. Wow. Busting in line on one hop. It's a touchback, first and 10 at the 20-yard line.
A little further, that one might have gone into the river out here, Tennessee River.
Reves has kicked off 53 times this year, and only 15 of them have been returned at all.
What a weapon.
It is indeed.
I think General Nayland would have liked that weapon himself.
Defense in the kicking game, you say. Johnny Jones.
Johnny Jones.
Just broke the Tennessee rushing record for a single season. Now he's on the way to try to get 1,000 and become the first Tennessee running back ever to get 1,000 yards in a single season. Weatherspoon. Got about two. They get second down and 8 yards to go at the 22. Jim Duncan made the tackle. Weatherspoon is from Nashville, Tennessee, 5'11", 185 pounder, and he is a freshman.
Stratford High School.
Vanderbilt has been this year disappointed and beset with injuries, and one of the most crippling came in the Maryland game, the opener, when they lost Manuel Young, their great safety. He was lost for the entire season. Then they give it to the tailback, and again it's Weatherspoon. Freshman popped it up there to about the 23, 24-yard line. Reggie White on the tackle.
Reggie White, they're All-American. He's a Lombardi Trophy candidate. There you see playing off a double team, still getting a piece in there. You'll see a lot of this young man today. 13 sacks. He's Tennessee's big play defensive lineman.
There are four finalists for the Lombardi Trophy Award, and Reggie White is one of them. Scott and Roach are the wide receivers for Vanderbilt. Page dropping back. Over the middle, and he's got him open. Tight end. Pop took it, Jim Pop. It's at the 42-yard line. First and 10.
This is the zone pass to the tight end. I say zone because the tight end comes into that dead spot in the middle of that zone and finds himself, sets down. The quarterback gets it right in there. Perfect shot against that double zone coverage that Tennessee's using.
4 minutes, 27 seconds left to play in the first quarter. You see Pop, number 81, going to his post tight end right. Running backs in the game are Keith Edwards and Louis Stevenson. Page, Kurt Page, and he finds an open man, and it's Edwards. Edwards gets across to the Tennessee 41-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go for the Vanderbilt Commodores. They're moving the football. Joe Cofer made the tackle.
You get the idea that Vanderbilt is not panicking. They're 10 points down, but they're not worried. They're going to chip away at the Tennessee defense. They're not going to do anything out of the ordinary. They keep chipping away. They know that if they keep hitting people like Keith Edwards, Jim Pop, the tight end, Chuck Scott, they're going to break some tackles, get the ball down there, and get some points.
First down and 10 yards to go at the Tennessee 41. Page has the ball. 10 to Pop. Tight end Pop, number 81, is struggling. And on down, inside the 20-yard line and all the way to the 16. First down and 10 yards to go for Vanderbilt at the Tennessee 16-yard line. Carl Zander, the linebacker. Dale Jones, the linebacker outside, made the tackle.
Bootleg off the counter fake. Now look at the counter fake right here. The halfback delayed a second, came across. This holds the linebackers, getting them moving to the left. Page moving out, looking back, which is what you should do on a bootleg when your outside receiver is covered. Comes back to Pop, who's in that little seam area. Popped it to him. He made a nice run.
First down and 10 outside the 16-yard line. Fuller and Roach to the wide receivers. This time they give it to the F-back, and he moves in. It's Keith Edwards, and he gets in ahead of the 11-yard line. Got about 5 yards on the play, and Mark Stettaway made the tackle with Dale Jones. Second down and 5 yards to go.
That time, Tennessee was employing a prevent-type defense, what they call a dime. It had six defensive backs in the game. Vanderbilt's had trouble moving the ball down inside the 20-yard line, punching it on in. Moved well between the 20s, but not inside.
That has been their problem. Inside the 20, 25-yard line, they've tended to bog down. This time they try the run and get it down to the 8-yard line with Stevenson carrying. Louis Stevenson. Picked up about 3 on the play. Joe Cofer made the tackle. Number 42. It's going to be third down about 1.5 yards. Ball is at the 8-yard line of Tennessee. 2 minutes, 25 seconds remaining in the first quarter. Tennessee leading 10-0. The Commodore is trying to get something on the scoreboard. Big Jim Pop comes back into the ballgame. Edwards and Stevenson are the setbacks. Give it on the ground, try to drive to get the first down, and it's Louis Stevenson. Now they'll have to take a long look at this one. He may have picked it up, and he may not. So they'll get him sorted out and take the look. The referee says, let's bring out the chain and see. The hit was made by Johnny Williams, who's on the nose, and Mark Stuttaway, who had a great game last week against Kentucky.
Stuttaway from Southside High School in Memphis. I think they've had a few other good football players in the years.
You bet.
I'll tell you this, he makes my All-SEC name team.
Oh,
Mark,
yes.
Stuttaway.
Like just about an inch, okay?
Just about an inch, the referee says. It's going to be fourth down. Just about an inch, and fourth down coming up for the Vanderbilt Commodores, who trail by 10 points. Ball is at the 7-yard line. They are going to send in John Patton to hold. Ricky Anderson kicks the field goals. He has had a 52-yarder against Alabama. This will be a 24-yarder. Ricky Anderson, a junior from St. Petersburg, Florida, from the hash mark left. Wade Smith is the center. John Patton waiting to get the snap. Puts it down Anderson's boots, and it is good. 24-yard field goal is booted by Ricky Anderson, and Vanderbilt is on the scoreboard. It is now Tennessee 10, Vanderbilt 3. And so now, let's go to New York to Brent Musburger.
Today's CBS telecast features Lindsey Nelson as a play-by-play announcer. Lindsey, who now lives in Knoxville, is a graduate of UT and at one time broadcast Tennessee games over the Ball Network. Today's game marks the first telecast Lindsey has ever originated from Neyland Stadium. Please make welcome Lindsey Nelson and Scott Hunter on the CBS Television Network.
This
There's not much to say to that, can you?
I think you're popular here. Boy, that's great.
It's marvelous.
I know you're just happy. I don't know another man in the broadcasting business and get up and come over to the stadium just a mile from his house and do a game.
Takes a lot of effort, doesn't it? Ricky Anderson's going to kick it off, the man who just kicked the field goal. Randall Morris is deep to receive it. Tennessee's been outstanding on kickoff returns. Here comes Anderson. Return of this one. It's across the end line. Way back there.
I figured out they need to move these kickers back to the 20-yard line to start kicking off in college football. Let's have a rule change.
They're getting distance, aren't they? So now Tennessee starts first and 10 at the 20. Alan Cockrell, the junior quarterback.
No question there that Vanderbilt, George McIntyre, wanted to get some points on the board just to break the ice. Did not want to go for the fourth and an inch.
Johnny Jones and Sam Henderson are the setbacks. Kick to the tailback, gunned it out in the left flat. And he's down. When the knee went down out there in college football, you're down. So it's on the 17-yard line. Clyde Duncan, the receiver. But they lost about three on the play. Windham was there for Vanderbilt. Second down and 13 yards to go back there at the 17.
Quick screen out to the flanker there, but watch out. A little later, you might see a long pass off that, I've been told.
Cooper has come in now, number 30, the blocking fullback. Johnny Jones stays in there running back. Alan Cockrell, number 6. Jones with the football. He's piling up yardage on the way to 1,000. He's down to the 31-yard line as Jeff Holt made the tackle. First and 10.
Glenn Streno from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Johnny Majors went back up there and got him. Having coached up there at Pittsburgh, won a national championship. Look at his leg drive. Look at his balance. He's on the man. He's on Beard until the ball carrier got way past him. What a follow-through and carry-through.
First and 10, Tennessee at their own 31-yard line. 41 seconds left in the quarter. Give it to Henderson. Big Sam Henderson, the fullback, got through the 35-yard line. Picked up four. It'll be second down and 6. Henderson was out with an injured shoulder at one point during the season. Windham and Jordan made the tackle for Vanderbilt.
Henderson from South Bend, Indiana. How did Johnny Majors steal him from one of those Notre Damers?
That's been a matter of some discussion, as a matter of fact.
Is it a secret here?
It's a secret to me. 10 seconds left in the quarter. George McIntyre facing along the sideline, the head coach at Vanderbilt. He's done an outstanding job. Was head coach at the University of Tennessee, Martin. That prior previous about Steve Sloan's staff at Vanderbilt. Time has run out in the period. So that is the end of the first quarter. And the score is Tennessee 10 and Vanderbilt 3 on a beautiful afternoon at Neyland Stadium in Knoxville, Tennessee. Cockrell throwing outside, complete across the 40-yard line. On across the 45 is Clyde Duncan. And Clyde Duncan, number 24, finally brought down at the 49-yard line of Tennessee. Steve McCoy made the tackle. Johnny Majors, head coach at Tennessee.
Johnny Majors came down here to build Tennessee back into national championship status. He's done exactly that. This is his second big year in a row. I think he's on the way and turned the corner here.
Today, he is looking for his 100th career coaching victory.
100 wins. Johnny Majors, great tailback here.
First and 10 at the 49-yard line. Cockrell has the ball. Passes outside to Duncan again, the other side. Duncan moves down to the 42-yard line of Vanderbilt. Steve McCoy from his linebacker spot made the tackle along with Leonard Coleman, the great cornerback on the left side. George McIntyre, head coach at Vanderbilt.
George McIntyre came to Vandy after Steve Sloan left. He's built a solid foundation there. He's got players coming back next year who are redshirted this year. He's going to have a great program. He's that type coach.
Second down, about a yard to go. First down. Jones goes across the sideline marker, and it'll be marked at the 33-yard line. Coleman forced him out.
Tennessee chipping away on Vanderbilt defense. They are not interested in gulping off yardage in big gulps. They just want to chip away, keep the ball down on the ground some, throw it out to Clyde Duncan on those little screens. This time Johnny Jones picks a hole, turns outside, picking up 8 or 9 yards. Exactly Tennessee's game plan is working well for them right now.
Johnny Jones has run for over 100 yards and more or more in 5 games this year coming into today's game. Jones has got the ball. He's got a hole, too. A lot of daylight, and Johnny Jones moves it down to the 15-yard line, first and 10. Visser and Thomas made the tackle for Vanderbilt. Johnny Jones moving the football.
Some blocking by Bill Mayo, the right guard from Dalton, Georgia. Steve Knight, the tackle out there. John Matthews. Some blocking by them. Jones has a... What a hole he had to go through there. Once he's in the secondary, he is a terribly dangerous runner. Dips the shoulder like the old-time Tennessee fullback Kurt Watson used to do. Picks up extra yardage.
Incidentally, Hank Larasella in 1951 is the only other Tennessee back ever to have 5 100-plus-yard games in one season. Kurt Watson has the career record of 7 100-yard games. We have now 13 minutes, 32 seconds left to play in the half. Tennessee leading by a score of 10-3. Back number 33 is now carried 9 times for 75 yards. He needs only 57 yards now to reach the 1,000-yard mark and to become the first Tennessee running back ever to rush for 1,000 yards in the season.
He looks like he's on his way.
Cockrell has thrown 6 for 6, 134 yards and 1 touchdown. At the 15-yard line, Jones with the ball. Not much this time. The Vandy defense rode him out just about the line of scrimmage. O'Connor made the tackle. Western Carolina 24, Colgate 23, and that's the final. Georgia 27, Georgia Tech 24, and that's the final. Georgia will be in the Cotton Bowl on CBS. Augustana, Illinois 21, Wisconsin La Crosse 15, and that's the final. Second down, 10 yards to go. Tennessee at the Vanderbilt 15-yard line. Jones and Morris in that backfield for Tennessee. Cockle completes another down inside the 10 to Randall Morris. He's at the 8-yard line. Anderson, Don Anderson made the tackle on the corner.
Tennessee had a perfect call against Vanderbilt's blitz here. Look at the blitz here. Number 20 coming in toughly. Had he gone for the quarterback, would have had him. He didn't. But ball a little bit behind Randall Morris. He had to turn around for it. Had he not had to turn around for it, he'd had an easy step into the end zone.
Third down and 4 yards to go. Inside the 10-yard line. Taco going. And he made the catch. Might be a little short of the first down. Might be about a foot short. Duncan made the catch. Leonard Coleman was the defender. It's going to bring up a fourth down. And from here, it looks as though it's less than a yard short. They've spotted the ball. They haven't taken it to the inbounds marker. Now they do. Fourth down. Tennessee is leading by a score of 10-3. 12 minutes, 40 seconds left in the half. Henderson is in there, so is Cooper and Jones. The power eye alignment, the power eye. Jones is the tailback. Big man, 245-pounder. Henderson is the fullback. Henderson. He might have got it. All he had to do is get about a foot. He might not. They'll look at this one now. Leonard Coleman made the hit. Vandy might take it over. They're going to bring out the chain. They're going to bring out the chain. This one is very close. If he did not make it, the ball goes over to Vanderbilt right there.
It's going to be close.
They did not make it. Vanderbilt takes over. The Vandy defense has held. And the Commodores get it first down and 10 yards to go at their own 5-yard line. It is still Tennessee 10 and Vanderbilt 3.
cheeks and on his head, he wants to beat Bama.
Hey, they've already beaten Alabama, and that's Vandy next.
But he's got help there on his left. As players resume now, Vanderbilt has the ball first and 10 at their own 5-yard line. They'll get a lift out of getting that ball there on downs. Kurt Page is the quarterback for the Lyon High School in Nashville, Tennessee. Whit Taylor, quarterback the Vanderbilt Commodores last year. He was a great one. Page has had an outstanding year at quarterback. From the end zone, Kurt Page. Across the sideline marker, incomplete. And now for an update, let's go to Brent Musburger in New York.
Lindsey, Tim Lasher of Oklahoma attempting a field goal against Nebraska. The Sooners trail it by 7 points.
If they stay in touch. Just about a yard is all they got. Louis Stevenson carried and Xander made the hit. The linebacker on the strong side.
Carl Xander not being blocked there by the Vanderbilt offensive line. Had a clean shot and he took it.
Second down, 9 yards to go at the 6.
Sometimes I think if I didn't play quarterback, I wouldn't have played this game.
Page again waiting for the snap. He's got it from the end zone. Page again. Overthrow. Incomplete. Any comment on that quarterback?
Page had a little tendency there to dog his receiver. He was looking all the time at where he was going to throw the ball. It just led the Tennessee defenders right to that spot.
So Ricky Anderson comes in to do the punting now. Tim McGee has dropped back to receive it for Tennessee, standing back at his own 49-yard line. McGee at the 47. To the 50, 45, and he was popped before he got to the 40-yard line. But Tennessee will take the ball in Vanderbilt territory. Mark Warner was the man who made the tackle. It will be first and 10 at the 41-yard line.
What a crowd, 91,000 plus. Tennessee rates up there with Michigan, I believe, is the two highest rated schools in the country in attendance on a yearly basis.
Well, they do. They have the two biggest college-owned football stadiums in the country. University of Michigan at Ann Arbor, the University of Tennessee at Knoxville.
Many great stories in here. Alabama and Tennessee over the years. Tennessee, Auburn. Oh, boy.
Ben Steno, the center, comes over the ball, and that is Alan Cockrell, the quarterback. Jones, and he's got a lot of running room. He's going to pick up a lot of yardage, and he might go. Jones. 41 yards and a touchdown for Jones. That leaves him only 16 short of 1,000. Fourth touchdown. Roger Bayes will attempt a conversion. Sells is holding his stop. And it's good.
No good back and run without a good offensive line. Mike Furness, Glenn Streno, Steve Knight, Bill Mayo clearing the hole for him through the Vandy defensive line. Once he gets in the secondary, though, then he's on his own. Then he can tear through tacklers like he does, use that low shoulder right into a touchdown. Tennessee grabs the lead 7-3 over the Vanderbilt Commodores.
Great rivalries is renewed as Bobby Knight leads the Indiana.
It'll be Tennessee kicking off, and it'll be Fouad Reveille seeing it up there at the 40-yard line. Johnny Jones now has carried 11 times for 116 yards, and Johnny Jones needs just 16 more yards to have rushed for 1,000 and become the first Tennessee running back in football history at Tennessee.
That's amazing. I would have thought coming into this season that many, many Tennessee backs have gone over 1,000, but that just shows you. Tennessee backs, great as they're always, but we got a good one playing here today.
Tell you a little something about that in a minute, about one particular back named Beatty Feathers.
Yes. He was the NFL's first 1,000-yard rusher.
First 1,000-yard rusher. That's what I was going to tell you. Parker waits in the end zone. He's going to run it out. Gets it out to about the 15-yard line. So now, for another update, let's go to Brent Musburger in New York.
Lindsey, yeah?
Spread formation. Page the quarterback. Guns it, and it's complete out in the left flat to about the 23-yard line. Taken by Louis Stevenson. Gain of 3 yards on the play.
So Stevenson.
Tennessee trying to take away Chuck Scott and Keith Edwards, their two highest receivers and number of catches. Edwards coming into the game with 90. Chuck Scott had 66, leaving Stevenson open, though.
Gain of about 7 on that last play, so make it second down. Fuller and Kelly are the wide receivers. Page with the ball. The middle, well, there's a dive for the interception. Did he get it before it hit the ground? He did. It's Reggie White. The deflected pass taken by 92. Reggie White on the interception. He still got it. He's going to take it home with him.
Well, one of those guys gets a chance for an interception, they make the most of it. Page back to pass. Tight end runs a quick little stop route right in the middle. The pass was okay. It was just one of those things that bumped off the shoulder pads. It looked like he didn't quite keep his eye on it. It's up in the air. Reggie White showing he can play basketball as well as football. Makes a dive, gets the rebound, and interception for him.
Interesting thing. He made the dive, and he made it. But when you look at the stats, it looks just like he reached high into the air, racing at full speed, and pulled it in. Interception.
All the same.
Johnny Jones.
Humble.
Yes, he did. But you can't advance it in college football. Might be down anyway. Risser is the man who picked it up. Risser still got it. As a matter of fact, Bearden made the hit. Steve Bearden. And Vanderbilt gets the ball, but you cannot advance a fumble in college football, so they simply get the football.
How many times have I seen that? A double turnover. One team getting one, the other team getting a turnover on the next play back. Coaches hate these psychologically. It could drop Tennessee a notch or two. Let's hope not. And here you see a good shot. Possibly didn't tuck away the ball like he should have. A good shot. Risser coming in, scooping it off the ground. Of course, you can't advance.
Sportsmanlike conduct over here.
Dead ball foul on sportsmanlike conduct against Vanderbilt.
Okay. Since that's dead ball, set up the chain.
So he'll have an enforcement here. He's right now at the 28-yard line with that ball. There he is. That's Risser, the man who picked up the football. He's happy about it. He'd have been happy if they'd let him run all the way into the end zone.
Guarantee you George McIntyre would.
Here the conclusion of today's CBS Sports NCAA football broadcast. Scott and I will be selecting a Chevrolet Most Valuable Player from each team. Chevrolet donates $1,000 and a scholarship to the General Scholarship Fund of each school. The MVPs receive certificates from Chevrolet acknowledging their outstanding performances. George McIntyre, head coach at Vanderbilt, looking on, saying, what's all of this? And Vanderbilt backed up down to the 14-yard line. Page in there ready to take the snap. McPherson wants to throw. And does throw. Kelly's got it. Up near the 50-yard line, he goes out of bounds. Joe Kelly, the receiver. Tommy Sims covering defensively for Tennessee. That's enough for the first down.
George McIntyre told me that Vandy would use the veer offense some and also the play action off the veer. This time, Page buys all kind of time by using the veer fake. Kelly runs a what they call a zig out or corner route. He had the tail cornerback turned all the way around. He was wide open. Good throw.
The interception a moment ago by Reggie White was his first of the year and only the eighth of the year for the entire Tennessee team. Well, the handoff to Stevenson.
Wow.
Out there just about the time that the defense did. He was really popped on that handoff from Page. Here are the NCAA leading receivers.
There you go. Edwards leading with 93 receptions. He's way up there. And there you see Chuck Scott, 66 receptions. He's been held to no receptions today, coming into the game with 66 receptions.
Vanderbilt is leading statistically in many, many categories, but they have not had a good year.
You watch Johnny Majors come down the line to get a little information. There was a loss of a yard on the last play. Ricky Holt made the hit for Tennessee. Here's Page. Incomplete, deflected. Keith Edwards, the man for whom it was intended. Third down, 11 yards to go at the 46. Tennessee is leading 17-3 with 9 minutes, 22 seconds remaining to be played in the first half here at Neyland Stadium in Knoxville, Tennessee.
That time, Mr. Reggie White was back there to say to Mr. Page, how do you do?
How do you do?
Exciting college football on CBS. Kurt Page, still quarterback. That's Page. Held it outside and over the head of his intended receiver, Keith Edwards. Let's check on some college basketball scores. The basketball season has begun, as you know. And Houston beat Kansas by a score of 91-76, and that's final. And Notre Dame beat Marist by a score of 75-68, and that is final. And Miami of Ohio and Oxford, Ohio beat Indiana 63-57. How about that?
Bobby Knight's probably angry about that.
He's angry all the time.
Perpetual angry.
Benton is waiting. Benton makes the catch. He's back to the 20. Gets it out to the 23. So Anderson's kick taken by Benton, and Tennessee will start at first and 10. It'll be spotted, I believe, near the 22-yard line. Tennessee still leading by a score of 17-3. Football, basketball doubleheader. At noon Eastern time, Florida State, head to their outstanding running back, Greg Allen, meets interstate rival Florida. And then at 4 p.m. Eastern, one of college basketball's great rivalries will be renewed as Bobby Knight's Indiana Hoosiers beat the powerful Kentucky Wildcats. It's all next Saturday on CBS Sports. When players resumed here, Tennessee has the ball first and 10. They have it at the 22-yard line. What I was going to make to you a moment ago about Beatty Feathers, here at Tennessee, of course, he never rushed for 1,000 yards in a single season because college football seasons were comparatively short then. Didn't play as many games. Then when he went to the Chicago Bears, he became the first running back in the history of the NFL to rush for 1,000. They played more games.
I would have guessed, watching Kurt Watson running up and down on the field in our defense in Alabama, he would have run for 1,000. Johnny Majors, of course, the Heisman Trophy runner-up to Paul Hornung. But you told me something I didn't know.
1,000 is a heap. Alan Cockrell to Johnny Jones.
Oh, fumble.
Fumble the football, and Vanderbilt's got it. Don't try to run with it. Same man, Risser. Wade made the hit, and Rick Risser made the recovery. He's got it. He's all over the football. He's holding up two fingers. That's twice he's done it. That's right.
Big turnover from Vanderbilt. Really big turnover from Vanderbilt. This time, Vanderbilt had Tennessee backfield position-wise. Tennessee 17-3 lead. Might have relaxed a little bit. Johnny Jones, he's run good today, but he's had a little trouble holding on to the ball. He was really stuck that time. It's out there by itself, just ready to be picked up.
Coach McIntyre says, now this has been their problem. With the football in this position, they've been unable to take it and right into the end zone. That's what they need to do. We'll see how they fare here. Shifted into an eye formation first. Gained 3 yards on the play. It'll be second down and 7. Fisher made the tackle along with Jones for Tennessee. George McIntyre along the sideline.
It's difficult for a lot of college passing offenses who don't have a quarterback that gets out and gets on the corner with an option to run or pass to score inside the 20. Makes it real difficult.
Edwards down to the 14-yard line.
George McIntyre. George telling me before the game that he was going to have to use the option, get Page out on the corner a little bit and hope to score to move the ball inside the 20. Doing that exactly that time.
Third down and about 3 at the 14. 7 minutes, 52 seconds left to play in the half. And a timeout for Vanderbilt. Kurt Page wants a timeout to check with the strategy staff along the sidelines and the head coach.
The brain trust, Lynn Amedee, offensive coordinator, taking over for Watson Brown, who left, went up to Cincinnati, now going to Rice.
There were rumors that Watson Brown might be here today. The Sun Bowl will be coming up at El Paso, Texas, Alabama versus SMU. That's December 24th at 3 p.m. Eastern, right here on CBS Sports. And the 46th annual Blue Gray game, Montgomery, Alabama. That's an all-star game, 12:30 Eastern time on Christmas Day, December 25th, and we'll be there. The Peach Bowl, Atlanta, Georgia, North Carolina versus Florida State, 3 p.m. Eastern on December 30th. The Cotton Bowl in Dallas, Texas, Texas versus Georgia, 1:30 Eastern time, January 2nd, and we'll be there. East-West Shrine game, Palo Alto, 1:30 Eastern time, January 7th, and we'll be there.
You've got quite a holiday lineup there.
Football coming your way on CBS Sports as George McIntyre gets the information from upstairs.
Talking to Lynn Amedee up here in the press box, the offensive coordinator. Lynn Amedee never started a game at LSU, but was the most valuable player in the Cotton Bowl in those years. One game away from a national championship. He was quite a player at LSU.
The players resume now. It'll be third down and 3 yards to go at the 14-yard line. Off Tennessee in Vanderbilt possession.
Big play.
Edwards on the right set. Scott and Brooks are the wide receivers. Page has got it. He's got the first down, and he's got a touchdown. Tommy Sims was there trying to veg him out, but he kept right on and took it in there for a touchdown. So this time the Vanderbilt Commodores were able to take advantage of the opportunity and move it straight into the end zone. Conversion attempt coming now. That was Page's second touchdown of the year. Ricky Anderson will attempt. John Patton will hold. Anderson will attempt. And it's good. So now the Vanderbilt Commodores have pulled to within 7 points. And for an update, let's go back to New York and Brent Musburger.
I tell you, Brent's really telling you something I didn't think would happen. Domination. All right, let's look at the touchdown. Kurt Page, we talked about it. George McIntyre has to get Kurt Page out on the corner. They've got to run the option to score inside the 20. Page being the runner, sort of like I was at Alabama, which isn't much. Page getting down there, forcing himself to the end zone with a little shot from the back there. Glad he's got his rib pads on. This is going to give Vanderbilt a big lift. You can be assured this is going to give them a big lift. Their biggest problem this year, they moved the ball all over the field inside the 20s, but could not put it in. This time, Kurt Page, the man that doesn't usually run, putting it in. And watch the shot he gets in the rib cage here to go ahead and put it in. One of his own guys. Glad he's got that flak jacket on.
Oh, my. Vanderbilt will kick it off now. Ricky Anderson will boot. Randall Morris is back, standing at the goal line. I noticed that most of those records that Walter Lewis broke for total offense were Scott Hunter records. If you couldn't run, how'd you get total offense?
Through a lot and a lot.
Then they were in Randall Morris in the end zone. He's going to not run it out. He took about two big strides and said, no, not today. Trying to be on play on the 20-yard line. Kurt there Page, it is, Kurt Page.
Taking over for Whit Taylor, Vandy's fine quarterback last year. One of my favorite all-time SEC quarterbacks, Whit Taylor. Page doing a good job for the Commodores today.
Alan Cockrell coming into the huddle now to run the attack. He's a junior quarterback at Tennessee. He's had very good games, and he has had very mediocre games during the course of this football season. Randall Morris and Johnny Jones are in the backfield. Tackle throwing outside, and it's complete for about 9 yards. Clyde Duncan, the receiver, second down and a yard to go. Tomorrow is an NFL doubleheader day on CBS Sports. In the first game, you'll see an important matchup between the Minnesota Vikings, leader of the NFC Central, and the New Orleans Saints, or the Philadelphia Eagles against the Washington Redskins. Then in the featured doubleheader game, it'll be the Green Bay Packers against the Atlanta Falcons, or the New York Giants taking on the Los Angeles Raiders. All starting with the NFL today at 12:30 Eastern. Check your local listings for the games in your area tomorrow on CBS Sports.
to go with the ball at the 29-yard line. Give it to the fullback and pick up the first and 10. It was Randall Morris carrying. He got to the 31 for the first down. John Windham made the tackle.
Anytime Tennessee needs 3 or 3 yards, just run behind center Glenn Streno. That's exactly what they did that time with a fullback. That big center has power and drive with his legs. Just get on his hiney and follow him.
Now the Volunteers bring big Sam Henderson, 245-pound fullback, into the lineup. He's the up back in that eye. Duncan and Taylor, wide receivers, said they give it to Johnny Jones. Well, he wedged him up there to the 38-yard line. He picked up 7. Here is today's attendance. The turnstile count, 93,426.
What was it when you first started doing the Vol Network?
About 30 was a big, big crowd.
It changed a lot, hasn't it?
A great deal. Gained him about 7 yards on the last play. Jones needs about 9 yards to reach 1,000 now. Second down and 3. The announcement will be made on the PA whenever he reaches 1,000. Let everybody beat the snap. I don't know who moved first. A lot of people moved second. Tennessee says Vandy move. Vandy says Tennessee move. Official say, let's see now. What do you got? What do you got?
I can say it real quick.
What do you got? You got to move with that? I got, here we are.
They sound as organized as we are.
We got illegal procedure against this team and illegal procedure against this team. Replay.
Replay the down and there's no penalty.
Coach Majors told me yesterday that Ole Miss was using some of Tennessee's snap counts and filling them off sides a few weeks ago. That might have been the case right there. Defensive signals sometimes sounding like snap signals, drawing the offensive line off.
There is Smokey.
That's not the Smokey that tried to bite me a few years back.
We had two Smokies. Second down, 3 yards to go. Castle, short drop, try to slam. Incomplete. Aaron Brown, and the penalty marker goes down. Aaron Brown is the intended receiver. Leonard Coleman. Is the corner there still on the ground? Outstanding performer for Vanderbilt.
Well, and unsportsmanlike conduct. That was an incomplete pass, so that's going from the previous spot, right?
Well, they got this straight. Incomplete pass goes to the previous spot.
The first foul is a personal foul against the defense.
Okay.
He's insinuating there's two fouls.
Sounded like that, doesn't it?
Hmm.
He's gone back to the previous spot now because it was an incomplete pass.
Okay, number two here.
What else will you tell us?
Got a dead ball foul, unsportsmanlike conduct, defense.
Unsportsmanlike conduct against Vanderbilt. Dead ball, that means after the play. Texas 45, Texas A&M 13, the final, and Texas will be in the Cotton Bowl on CBS against Georgia on January 2nd.
Dead ball.
Union, New York 23,
defense.
Salisbury State 21, that's a final.
First down.
Indiana State 16, East Illinois 13. Second overtime, final. Two overtimes.
Vandy just suffering a 30-yard double penalty situation.
First and 10 at the 32. One more penalty, they'll be in the old World's Fair site. Mr. Jones doesn't need much to reach 1,000, but he's not going to get much here. Vandy defense flooding over there. Steve Bearden leading the way along with Tom Moore. Gain of a yard on the last play for Jones. It'll be second down and 9. Here comes the big fullback Henderson in again. Jones is the tailback, number 33. Henderson, number 43, is the fullback. Jones, and he was really popped. He was really popped by Willie Twyford from Winter Haven, Florida. Penalty marker on the play.
defense.
Vanderbilt offside. So although the Vandy defense threw Tennessee for a loss, an offside penalty of 5 yards will be inflicted.
Vandy was trying to time a blitz right there. Apparently, the guy who was blitzing, Rick Risser, a little bit too anxious there.
Offside, defense, second down.
Second and four, Tennessee at the Vandy 26. Tennessee is leading 17-10. We have 4 minutes, 46 seconds left to play in the first half.
A quarterback's dream, second and three.
Aaron Brown's in the wide right. Jones and Henderson are the setbacks in the I formation. Jones. Trying to get to the outside. Risser made the tackle. And now for another update, let's go to Brent Musburger in New York.
Lindsey, after an Oklahoma...
I tell you, this is almost unbelievable.
Brandon, I'll tell you, that's some reporting. That's a shocking score.
Third and two on the 24. Third and two. Power eye formation, short yardage. Give it to the tailback. Jones again. It's close. It's just close is all I can tell you.
Excellent blocking by Kurt Singer, Mike Furness here. Tennessee knows on drive blocking, they've got Vanderbilt outweighed. They are a little stronger up front. They know they can run straight at Vanderbilt in these tough situations.
And they picked up the first and 10. 2 yard gain for Johnny Jones.
I don't think General Leland would have disagreed with that at all.
Not straight in the state. North and south, they used to say, is the way you want to run those east-west runners and kill you. Double receivers to the right side. Lenny Taylor, Clyde Duncan over there. McGee to the left side.
He's audible.
Beg your pardon, Claren Brown to the left side. Johnny Jones got 3 yards to the 19-yard line. Second down and seven now. Bob O'Connor made the tackle.
Alan Cockrell standing at the line of scrimmage looking the defense over, either calling an even signal or an odd signal, odd or even number, telling the rest of the team which way the play will be run. To the left, usually odd. To the right, usually even.
And now Johnny Jones needs 1 yard to reach 1,000 and become the first Tennessee back in history to race for 1,000. I'm sure the announcement will be made to the crowd when he does, if he does. I presume he will. He hasn't got the ball. Cockrell's got the ball. Incomplete after Randall Morris. 2 minutes, 36 seconds remaining to be played in the half. Clock stopped on the incompletion to Morris. Third down and seven.
Well, it makes coaches pull their hair out, but nobody ever dropped one on purpose.
Johnny Majors is taking off the headset temporarily. A little communication. There's the time remaining in the first half. Duncan's in a wide right now. Cockrell audibilizing at the line of scrimmage. He's got it. On the slant, it's incomplete. Lenny Taylor, number two. It'll be fourth down now. Kermit Sykes covering defensively.
Excellent call by Tennessee. Excellent call against the blitz. Vanderbilt bought a safety blitz that time. Came down in a slant pattern. The pass was just a little high. Cockrell missed him with it, or it might have been six for the Vols.
Jack Sells comes into hole. Swab Gervais will attempt, the junior from Miami, Florida. And this will be a 36-yarder from the hash mark left. Sells puts it down. Gervais boots it up. It carries. And it's good. And the field goal for Swab Gervais. Three more points for the Volunteers. Tennessee 20 and Vanderbilt 10.
Johnny Jones close to that 1,000-yard mark. As I said, I'm surprised that no other Tennessee back has ever gone over that 1,000-yard mark. Kurt Watson, I thought, but Johnny, some of the others.
We invite you to stay with us during the halftime intermission because the NCAA today will have information about the Nebraska Academic Advisor feature. CBS News will bring us an update on news around the world, and we'll have scores and highlights of the big games that are being played today, and there are lots of them.
Cockrell is now 9 of 11 in the air, 152 yards and one touchdown. Jones has carried 8 outs for 131 yards and needs only one.
You keep hearing us talk about Kurt Watson. I found out having breakfast with him this morning, he's going to be a Navy Blue Angel.
That's what I hear.
Pretty dangerous work, but I'm sure it's fun.
Parrish is back there along with Anderson to get the kickoff by Fuad Reves. Spotter Bill Friel peering intently down him because the shadows are lengthening. Reminds him of yesterday when we both were in Boston and the lights went on. Ball to second at the goal line by Parrish, by Parker. And Parker comes up to about the 16-yard line. Stopped by Tom Welch.
Interesting situation for Vanderbilt right here. They'd like to go the length of the field for a score touchdown with 2 minutes 21 seconds to go. They'd like to get a field goal, but more than that, they've also got a guard against a turnover right here. A turnover and a Tennessee score would put them down 27 or 23 to 10. Tough to go to halftime like that.
Quarterback Kurt Page is 8 of 15 in the air for Vanderbilt, 124 yards. Page with the football for Vandy. Completes it out in the right flat, up to the 19-yard line to Louis Stevenson. And a three on the play. It'll be second down and seven. Let's take a look at some scores now. Central State of Ohio 24 and Southwest Texas State 16, a final. Here are basketball scores. Iowa 86, Illinois Wesleyan 60. That's the final. And it is Toledo 30, Michigan 27. That's a halftime basketball score. Kurt Page waiting. He's got the ball. He is sacked by Reggie White, the Minister of Defense, number 92.
Johnny Majors asked me why I quit playing football. Here's the reason that I don't still play quarterback. Kurt Page back. Reggie White coming off the tackle. A little bit of hesitation there by Page trying to find a receiver, and Reggie White sticks him in the ground.
Loss of 10 yards on the play. Third and 17. 1:34 remaining in the half. Kurt Page with the ball for Vanderbilt. Tried to flip it forward. Somebody better throw a ball on it. Simply forward pass behind the line, incomplete. Louis Stevenson was the man there. And fourth down's coming up. And so we have the punting unit coming on for Vanderbilt. Ricky Anderson will do the punting.
Vanderbilt trying the shuffle pass, we call it, Utah pass, whatever you want to call it. You go back, you set up, you let the halfback delay, then come down at an angle. That time wasn't handled very cleanly.
It is taken at the 43-yard line by Benton, and he was hit immediately. So it'll be first down and 10 yards to go.
Tennessee in excellent field position here with a minute 16 seconds to go to do exactly like we talked about, get 3 or 7 points on the board.
They're inside the 44. Next Saturday, Florida State at Florida, and that'll be on with the NCAA today at 12 Eastern time right here on CBS, and we'll be there. Basketball also, the second part of the doubleheader, Indiana and Kentucky. What a rivalry that is. That is next Saturday. Cockrell,
screen,
going to screen right. Randall Morris has got it. Morris fumbles the football. The scramble is on at the 33-yard line. Who got the ball? Well, Tennessee got the ball. Jones, I think, was on the ball. Johnny Jones. Try this one just right up the middle. That Randall Morris, Garrett.
That ball had more twists and turns on that fumble than a Mississippi country road.
You're right. Steve Bearden made the tackle. He's from Birmingham, Alabama. 37 seconds on the clock remaining in the half. Tennessee is leading 20 to 10. Now we're getting a timeout signal. Timeout, Tennessee. Timeout for the Orange.
and play is resumed. The clock will start on the snap, and we will have 37 seconds left to play in the half. Final game of the regular season for both these teams. Stay with us during the halftime intermission. Reports from the NCAA today. The Nebraska Academic Advisor feature. CBS News will provide us with an update of news around the world, and then we'll have scores and highlights of other football games being played today.
And Brent Musburger's cut-ins on that Nebraska-Oklahoma game have been shocking.
They really have. I'm anxious to find out what else has happened in that game. Go away for a few minutes, there's no telling. Well, you've had a chance for a day or two to visit around in Knoxville and see some football people, and there are quite a few back here, pro players who played on Thursday and things like that. They're all around.
Sure are. John Ward, Dallas Cowboys kicker, who was injured early in the season back. Saw quite a few people here.
Bates is also here.
Bill Bates, that's right.
Who's had an outstanding season with the Dallas Cowboys. He's become a folk hero in Dallas.
I always like those Thursday games in pro football, unless you were playing at the Lions.
Here we go. Clock starts on the snap. 37 seconds.
Blitz look.
First down play. Long pass down to the end zone. Incomplete. That's Clyde Duncan. Moxon Hill, Maryland. And Kermit Sykes is covering him very closely.
Charlie Mack Alexander, who does the Commodore radio, told me that Kermit Sykes might be the best defender in their backfield back there. Going into the game, of course, Leonard Coleman, thought of by the pro scouts as a great pro prospect, but Sykes has had an excellent season.
A good many pro scouts here today, as a matter of fact.
Gil Brandt, I saw earlier this morning, had a cup of coffee with him.
Gil Brandt of the Dallas Cowboys, Baby Ray of the Green Bay Packers, former Vanderbilt star. Dennis Cooper's in there now with Randall Morris, and that is Cockrell back to throw, and it's incomplete at the 25-yard line. Got it out to Randall Morris, but he couldn't hang on, and Morris is down. That's he right there. It'll be third and 10 at the 33-yard line.
Looked like he took a shot in the ribs and called Jordan or Bob O'Connor. Randall Morris dropping the ball. Of course, the linebacker not knowing it was dropped.
Carco's been over to the sideline to get a little information. While members of the training staff are working on Randall Morris.
Randall Morris coming out of the backfield doing a stop route. No linebacker there. Cockrell read the thing excellently. He was looking downfield for the post route, but knew he could take this one, move that ball a little closer down there. Ball is down on the ground. Oh, goodness. Looking at that knee. I hope that's nothing serious.
Randall Morris is a senior from Long Beach, California. He's 6 feet tall, 185-pounder. Came into this game today having averaged 5.2 yards per carry this year, rushing for 408 yards and one touchdown. He's been used at fullback, he's been used at tailback, and he has been used in a very excellent role of returning kickoffs.
There you go, a shot of this 91,000-plus crowd. The ball's Tennessee River's right behind that end zone sign there. See all the yachts docked here, come up for the games.
Well, we used to call it the Tennessee River, and now we call it Fort Loudoun Lake. It's the same body of water, it's at the same place.
Jogging beside it today, hadn't changed in beauty world.
There you go. There it is right there. Fort Loudoun Lake. And the bridge is nearby.
I think we can see your house over there in those woods.
Not in that direction, but it's close. Here we go. Third down, 10 yards to go. At the 33-yard line. All the way down to the 18-yard line, Johnny Jones, and that should have done it. Tom Moore made the tackle. Penalty marker on the play might nullify. Penalty marker on the play might nullify the Joan Jardy. Holding is indicated against the Volunteers. Illegal use of hands, same thing.
Come here, give me the captain right there.
What we talked about earlier, Tennessee going in has been plagued this year with penalties, busted assignments, interceptions, and such as that. Johnny Jones has been Tennessee's biggest weapon. Even in the two-minute offense here, he's taking the ball behind Glenn Strino's block. Bill Mayo putting an excellent block on there. Once you get this guy into the secondary, he's extremely dangerous. I'm surprised he didn't block that one or break that one for a touchdown.
Illegal use of hands, 5 yards.
5 yard penalty moves it back to the 35-yard line.
19 seconds to go in the half here.
That makes it only third and 12 because the penalty was marked off from the 30-yard line. Line of scrimmage had been to 33.
Clock was running.
Third and 12 at the 35. 10 seconds left to play in the half. Still running down to 8-7. 6-5, 4. Hackle ready to throw. Unloads it to Henderson, and Henderson is being ridden over near the sideline at the 30-yard line. Time has run out on the clock. At the 30, McCoy and Bearden made the stop, and time has run out in this period. So our score is Tennessee 20 and Vanderbilt 10. We'll be back with scores and highlights, and we'll be visiting with Brent Musburger after this word about an upcoming show on CBS and a message from your local station. At Neyland Stadium in Knoxville, Tennessee, now it'll be Vanderbilt kicking off to start the second half. Ricky Anderson will kick it out. Randall Morris is deep for Tennessee. Shaken up in the first half, he has recovered, and he's waiting at the 2-yard line. Morris, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35. Morris down to the 36-yard line. So it is first down and 10 yards to go. Tennessee with the ball just across the 35.
Tennessee, a great kickoff return team. That time, Randall Morris bringing it back 34 yards, setting up Tennessee on the 36 in good field position.
Alan Cockrell, the quarterback. He quarterbacked them throughout the first half. Johnny Jones and Sam Henderson are in the I formation. Cross is Taylor in motion. Jones looking for the yard, and I think he stretched out and got it with that last lunge of his body. Bearden made the tackle.
I would think Johnny Majors would like to punch the ball down Commodore's throats right now, move the length of the field and score. Let's see if the Commodore defense can hold it.
The announcement's being made now that Johnny Jones has become the first Tennessee running back to rush for 1,000 yards in a single season. He did it with that last lunge.
Johnny Jones.
First and 10 across the 36-yard line. 20 carries, 135 yards for Jones. Timeout, Tennessee. Timeout for the Volunteers. They are congratulating Johnny Jones, the tailback, who has been ushered into the annals of Tennessee football history here this afternoon. Cockrell is 11 for 15 in the air, 160 yards and one touchdown. Johnny Jones just having gone for 1,000 of the season. Earlier this year against Rutgers, he set the Tennessee all-time single-game record. 41 carries, 234 yards. Cockrell throwing, and it's intercepted at the 40-yard line. Picked off by Steve McCoy of Vanderbilt. First and 10, Vandy at the Tennessee 41.
Cockrell coming back off the play-action fake here. The tight end coming across on the linebacker. Never really cleared the linebacker. Steve McCoy, who Vanderbilt calls their Falcon linebacker after defensive linebacker coach Pete von Falkenberg, picks it off. Vanderbilt in good shape at the Tennessee 41-yard line.
So the Commodores trail by 10 points, and they have the ball in Tennessee territory. Kurt Page, the quarterback from Nashville, Tennessee, up here. Running backs in an I formation. To the tailback, the pitch back. There's a ball flicker. Hayes with a long one to the end zone. And it's in, it's incomplete. Incomplete. Simply an incomplete pass. That was Charlie Davis back there trying for the interception and the touchback. Phil Roach, the man for whom it was intended, the flea flicker for Vanderbilt.
He certainly aired it out. He had to do it early, though, because Reggie White was coming. A play like this has to have timing, and you've got to get rid of the ball quickly. Probably the reason it was not complete, Reggie White getting back there and forcing the pass to be thrown a little quicker than it should have.
Second down and 10 yards to go. Kurt Page with the football for Vandy. Incomplete. Trying to complete it down there about the 30-yard line to Chuck Scott, his tight end. Third down and 10 yards to go. Vandy at the Tennessee 41. Chuck Scott came into this game today with 66 completions.
Chuck Scott is really not a tight end. He's more like something between a wide receiver and a tight end, and he's a good one.
Third Third down play, third and 10. Page falls down. And when you fall down in college football and the knee hits, you're down. So it's at the 48-yard line. Now for an update, let's go to Brent Musburger in Newton. Right here now. It is punt formation for Vanderbilt. Ricky Anderson doing the punting, and Benton is back. McGee is out with an injury, by the way. McGee was injured in the first half. Tried to down it. Did he make it? Perhaps he did on the one-yard line. Down on the one-yard line. Oh, my.
He caught the ball at the end of the end zone, but still he caught the ball in the field of play, and that's where the referee spots it, Tennessee from the one.
Carl Parker down the ball on the one-yard line.
Lindsey and I were talking about this. I have never seen this in all the time I've been watching college football. I've never seen a guy field a ball in the air on the one-yard line, go into the end zone, and then bring it back and spot on the one. Mr. Nelson, your history.
Well, take a look, because you'd see it again right here.
There's always a time for a first.
There's the reaction.
Whatever the case is, Tennessee's ball back on their one-yard line.
The Volunteers are backed up to their own one-yard line. Tennessee is leading by a score of 20 to 10. Jones, the tailback. Henderson is the fullback. Formation. Give it to Henderson. Well, he got a yard. After the two-yard line, that'll be second down and nine. Vandy trying to force any kind of a mistake here on the part of the Volunteers now to get that ball deep in Tennessee territory. Abdabo Connor made the tackle.
I'm sure George McIntyre would like to have that series back if Vanderbilt got the interception one time before and make something happen with it, but it just didn't happen. He needs to hold him out there. He's exhorting his defense.
Second down play. 9 yards to go on the two. From the end zone, Conklin outside. Gets it out to the 7-yard line on the completion to Taylor. Lenny Taylor, the receiver from Miami, Florida. Again, a five. It'll be third down and four. Tom Moore made the tackle.
Tennessee's offensive coordinator, Walt Harris, giving Alan Cockrell the green light anywhere on the field to throw the ball. I like it.
As a quarterback, you like it, right?
Yes. As a head coach, I wouldn't like it.
Clyde Duncan, a wide receiver, to the left side. Here's the pass to Clyde Duncan, and it's incomplete. Duncan trying to run under it out there about the 30-yard line. That'll bring up a fourth and four, and Tennessee will have to punt. Leonard Coleman was covering with Rick Risser.
George McIntyre getting his wish for his defense to get in there and hold Tennessee and get the ball back in good field position.
Tennessee is kicking for the first time today. Jimmy Colquitt, who had a slight ankle sprain in the Kentucky gym last week. He has averaged 41.8, his longest 70-yarder. Rick Risser has dropped back at his own 45 to field it for Vanderbilt. Commodore should come out of this in pretty good field position, depending, of course, always on the kick by Colquitt. Well, he really boosts it. Taking up the 37-yard line to the 40. Risser to the 45 to the 50 and out of bounds. In Tennessee territory at the 49-yard line. Pivot, bend him out. First and 10 for the Commodores when play is resumed. They'll have the ball at the Tennessee 49-yard line. But next Saturday, a college football basketball doubleheader on CBS. At noon Eastern time, Florida State, led by their outstanding running back, Greg Allen, meets interstate rival Florida. And then at 4 Eastern time, one of college basketball's great rivalries will be renewed as Bobby Knight's Indiana Hoosiers meet the powerful Kentucky Wildcats. What a rivalry that is. It's all next Saturday on CBS Sports. Coker's punt with 57 yards, returned 15. Vandy with the ball first and 10 at the Tennessee 49.
Very important series here for Vanderbilt.
Kurt Page, the quarterback for Vandy, swings it out to the right flat. Complete out there for a loss of 2 yards to Louis Stevenson. Reggie White, the 92, you see there. Along with Xander and Toews. Second down and 12 yards to go. Penalty marker.
Right here at this spot where the run ended, really. Clipping.
Clipping against Vanderbilt. be marked off from the spot where the run ended, according to what we overheard from the referee.
Vanderbilt having the ball twice inside the Tennessee 50-yard line now has come out of them in bad shape both times. This time getting a 15-yard penalty on the quick screen. Kurt trying to look downfield, look the linebackers off. You see the clip right there. That's what happens sometimes with these quick screens when people are coming out the offensive line. Lateral pursuit sometimes leads to clipping.
Well, it is first, but it's 28 at the 34-yard line. Fuller and Roach to the wide receiver. Bring him out. Kurt Payne. Well, they try that little forward flip. Utah pass to Stevenson. He goes nowhere. It's going to be marked at the 36 for a gain of two. It was Reggie White, number 92 again.
Reggie White burying the ball carrier under a sea of orange. He leading the charge.
Second down and 26 yards to go. Vandy at their own 36. Red Page. Incomplete. Penalty marker is thrown right there. It was intended for Roach. But that was Sims. Tommy Sims made a move on him, and the marker was thrown.
I got to call it non-accessible.
Okay. All right, you got a personal foul. You got an illegal use of hands.
Okay, let's go 10 yards. Illegal use of hands.
But it was while the ball was in the air.
Yeah.
So it's no first down.
Okay, well, then talk to me about this. All right, now the ball did go out of bounds, way out of bounds.
It's not catchable ball. That's what you're saying, okay? Not catchable ball.
Well,
so therefore,
him and hits him and
it's 10 yards and no first down. Right. Okay? Illegal use of hands, 10 yards, no first down. Holding defense.
Now, if you ever wondered how the officials work on penalties, you just overheard the way they do it. And if there's more than one official and more than one call, he says, what do you got? And he says to the other, what do you got? And he tries to put it all together.
Need a calculator and a wizard out there to figure that all out.
You do. And while they do that, let's go to Brent Musburger in New York for another update.
Wow. That looked like Bo Jackson of Auburn.
And Oklahoma is playing some kind of a football game against Nebraska, which has been touted really as a super team this year. It still is, for that matter. All right, the line of scrimmage is the 46-yard line. Second down and 16. Page rolling and looking and wanting to throw. And a diving catch at the 35-yard line, which will be enough for a first down. It was Fuller. Ardell Fuller made the diving catch.
Vanderbilt has had enough of Reggie White sacking Kurt Page. This time they're going to the rolling screen. He comes back like he's going to drop back, but he rolls to his left to buy time to pressure the defense, to stretch them. That's exactly what happens. You see a lot of Tennessee defenders going laterally in your screen. It left a hole, and he put it right in there.
Tennessee is leading by a score of 20-10. Vanderbilt driving here. First and 10 at the Tennessee 35. And a big opener. Edwards with running room all the way down to the 12-yard line. Keith Edwards stopped by Kofor and Davis, the safety man. So now the Vanderbilt Commodores, first and 10 at the Tennessee 12-yard line. Page is looking over at the sideline for his next play.
That was a big play for Vanderbilt.
McIntyre. Edwards and Stevenson to the back. Edwards got the pitch. He went out of bounds at the 10-yard line. Harry Brown ran him out.
Keith Edwards coming into this game as Vandy's best all-purpose running back. 837 yards receiving, 168 yards rushing. He's adding to his total on the ground today, as well as in the air.
Second down and 8 yards to go. Vandy at the Tennessee 10-yard line. Yeah. second clock. It's down to 12 now. Timeout. Timeout. Timeout called by Kurt Faith. He's going to go to the sidelines. So the score is still Tennessee 20, Vanderbilt 10, with 9 minutes 36 seconds left in the third quarter of this game. Musburger right here. Vanderbilt has the ball. Second down. 7 yards to go at the 9-yard line of Tennessee. Kurt Page, the quarterback. Page. Touchdown. Touchdown, Vanderbilt. Into the end zone, the sharp pass to Phil Roach. Phil Roach with his fourth touchdown catch of the year for Vanderbilt. 20-16, a conversion attempt coming now. Ricky Anderson will attempt it. John Patton will hold. Patton puts it down, booted up, and it's good. So it is now Tennessee 20 and Vanderbilt 17.
Now we've seen Vanderbilt running the veer that you know Kurt Page scored on it earlier. They run the veer fake this time to hold the linebackers. Phil Roach runs a quick post behind the linebackers. Page zotted it right in there. Now, Vanderbilt does a lot of plays to set up other plays. This is exactly the way Leon Amendy, the offensive coordinator of Vanderbilt, wanted to work. It did at that.
So now, with 9 minutes, 31 seconds left in the third quarter of the football game here at Neyland Stadium on the campus of the University of Tennessee in Knoxville, it will be Vanderbilt kicking off. The NFL tomorrow, Minnesota at New Orleans or Philadelphia at Washington, starting with the NFL today at 12:30 Eastern time. And then Green Bay at Atlanta or the New York Giants at the Los Angeles Raiders at 4 Eastern time. That's all tomorrow on CBS Sports. Kicking it off, Ricky Anderson. Randall Morris has dropped back to receive it for Tennessee.
We've got ourselves an old-fashioned Vanderbilt, Tennessee battle.
Just what we've got right here. Waiting for the signal from the referee, and we get it. Dick Burleson is the referee here today. Morris at the goal line, 5, 10, 15, 20. Morris to the 25-yard line, first down and 10 yards to go for Tennessee. So now, can the Volunteers move the ball against the Vandy defense? DeGroote made the tackle on Morris coming up the field.
Momentum is sometimes an overblown term, but what else is there? Right now, Vanderbilt has the momentum. Tennessee has got to try to get it back by rattling that chain and getting some first downs.
Alan Cocco brings them up. Tries to leave it into Henderson close, and he gets out there for about 2 yards to the 27-yard line. Steve Bearden made the tackle. Second down and 8 yards to go. Here's the last scoring drive. 7 plays, 49 yards, 2 minutes, 38 seconds. 9-yard touchdown pass, Page to Roach.
We said it was an important series for Vanderbilt that last time, having had the ball in Tennessee's inside their 50 the time before, and they scored with it. That got him better off.
Cockrell, Cockrell, Cockrell. He did not get rid of Willie Twyford. Cockrell is sacked by Willie Twyford of Vanderbilt.
Very important series for Tennessee. We just spoke about Tennessee needing to move the ball. They're coming with a play-action fake this time, but Willie Twyman came off the block a little too quick. He wasn't thinking play-action. He wasn't thinking run. He was thinking get that passer, exactly what he did.
Third and 16. Back at the 19-yard line. for Cockrell. Try the draw play to Jones. Johnny Jones. He's got the first down at the 41-yard line. Bearden and Sykes made the stop for Vandy. Tried the draw play.
This has to be one of the finest performances of any Tennessee running back ever. Johnny Jones taking the draw. It was a call by Johnny Majors just to get Tennessee maybe a little more kicking room, but not this guy. He's dangerous. He's a dangerous weapon. He's thrown into the secondary by that Tennessee offensive line, and then he does the rest of it. First down, Tennessee.
Jones has come off the field momentarily. Chuck Coleman is in the ballgame at tailback. That is Jones along the sideline. Johnny Jones, 21 rushes, 156 yards. This is Chuck Coleman carrying, the senior from Louisville, Kentucky. Missed much of the year with an injury. He's out to the 43-yard line for a gain of 3, making it second down and 7. Carl Jordan made the tackle for Vandy. Here comes Cooper in at fullback. He's the blocker. Henderson comes out. Duncan's coming to a wide left, and also to the left side is Lenny Taylor. Coleman and Cooper are the backs in the I formation. Cooper is running in fullback. Pitch to Coleman. Chuck Coleman to the 37-yard line. Windham made the tackle. First and 10, Tennessee at the Vandy 37.
This is the counter option that's really not a counter option. Alan Cockrell making a quick play to the fullback. It's really not an option that he wants the quarterback to keep the ball. He goes out, he freezes the end, pitches to Chuck Coleman. This is the play that Tennessee went 66 yards on Alabama to win the game on almost again.
First down play now. Give it to the fullback this time, and Henderson. It's in there just past the 35-yard line. Willie Twyford made the tackle. Gain of about 2 on the play. Call it second down and 8 yards to go. Tennessee's leading in the game by a score of 20-17. Cooper coming back in with the next play. Henderson comes off the field.
Probably Tennessee's most important drive yet.
Chuck Coleman is still in there at tailback. Cooper is the blocking fullback. Incomplete in the end zone. Covering was Coleman. Laron Brown is the man for whom it was intended. Leonard Coleman, the left cornerback for Vanderbilt, and a good one, was covering defensively. That's he right there.
Still an excellent throw by Alan Cockrell. He hung the ball up where the receiver could catch it or nobody.
Third down and 8 yards to go. 5 minutes, 51 seconds remaining in the third quarter. Cooper comes off the field. Henderson comes back in as fullback. Clyde Duncan, far to the right side. They're in a slot right. Brown is wide to the left side. Cockrell. Ties it to Brown again. Same coverage. Coleman's there. Incomplete. Coleman almost picked it up. Coleman thought perhaps he had held it long enough. He had not. It's an incompletion. Same coverage, same receiver. Fourth and 8 now. Line of scrimmage is the 35. And here comes Fouad Reves. Here comes Reves. It'll be a 52-yarder. He has not had a field goal over 50 yards this year. His career high is 60, which is the Southeastern Conference record against Georgia Tech last year. 52-yard attempt.
He has the range. It's makeable.
And it is no go. Wide to the right side. So Reves three times this year has tried outside the 50 and has not converted one. The ball goes over to Vanderbilt. They trail by only 3 points. 5:37 remaining in the third quarter. So now can the Commodores of Vanderbilt move this football?
Now it's time for that Tennessee defense to rise up. Some of those old great ones like Bobby Majors, who I just saw. I bet some of the Tennessee people wish they were back on the field.
You bet. Well, the Tennessee-Vanderbilt game is one of the series that brings out a lot of the old grads. They come back. It's sort of an intrastate battle, of course. Knoxville, Nashville,
state university against the private school.
Here we go.
Great plays the quarterback. He's got the ball. Did he stay in? Yes, he did. At the 45-yard line. Gathered by Chuck Scott. Tommy Sims was covering defensively.
Just an excellent route. Just an excellent throw. This is textbook coaching clinic passing game. Play action fakers. Seal the linebackers. Kurt Page whipping the ball over the linebacker's head. Look at this catch. Look at the footwork, Chuck Scott. You don't do it any better than that.
They're in a slot left. They widen out a receiver to the right side. And that is Chuck Scott, who's wide right. Page, the quarterback. Tries to give this one to Edwards. Edwards sprints through to the 39-yard line. Picked up 5 yards, and now for another update, let's go to New York and to Brent Musburger. Oklahoma made him mad. That's what they did. They stirred him up. 4:59 left to play in the third quarter here. Second down play. Edwards again. This time pops through to the 34-yard line. Reggie White made the tackle.
We have a smoke. Much of that Vanderbilt offensive line, Will Wolford, Mark Herman, but they're doing a good job over there on the left-hand side.
The Commodores are moving steadily downfield. They picked up a first down with that last one. It's first and 10 now. Vanderbilt at the Tennessee 35-yard line.
I throw in Rob Monaco there, excellent prospect.
Kurt Page getting things straightened out there on the field. Edwards moves to the right set. Louis Stevenson moves to the left set. Edwards. Pass for 2 to the 33-yard line. Second down and 8 yards to go. Reggie White made the tackle.
And Reggie White.
Yards rushing. Tennessee 184, Vanderbilt 50.
And usually most games are decided by who rushes the most, yardage-wise and number of carries. That in favor of Tennessee right now, but Vandy is closing it.
Second down, 8 yards to go for the Commodores of Vanderbilt. Ardell Fuller going to the left side. Roach is going to the left side. Here comes Scott to the right side. Edwards and Stevenson to the setbacks. Stevenson up, Edwards on the tail. Page has the ball. He never had a chance. Reggie McKenzie, number 51 from Knoxville, Tennessee.
What caused this sack was excellent coverage by the defensive backfield. Tony Sims out there. Kurt Page came back, was looking for his wide receiver downfield. He just was not open. He had to eat the ball, did not want to throw it up there for an interception. Excellent coverage by the Tennessee secondary, resulting in a sack.
Third and 16, Vanderbilt at the Tennessee 41. Phil Roach going to a wide left. Ardell Fuller coming to a wide right. Edwards and Stevenson in the backs. Page. Wide open is Fuller. Ardell Fuller with a diving catch at the 22. That's the first and 10 for Vanderbilt.
Motion sometimes confuses defensive secondaries. This coverage is called double man. The two back guys are taking the back halves of the field. The up front guys are supposed to take the wide receivers man to man. But you see confusion there by Tennessee's left up cornerback. It leaves the man in the middle, Ardell Fuller, wide open.
The Vanderbilt Commodores trailing by 3. Have it first down and 10 yards to go at the Tennessee 22 late in the third quarter. Edwards. To the 20-yard line, he picked up 2, and so it'll be second down. And 8 yards to go. Johnny Williams on the nose, made the tackle. He's from Fulton High School in Knoxville, Tennessee. 2 minutes and 12 seconds remaining to be played in the third quarter now. Tennessee 20 and Vanderbilt 17.
Oh, coach is pulling the hair. Oh, boy. I'm glad I'm up here in the broadcasting booth and my stomach is not turning over.
Running backs are split for Kurt Page. Page to Scott. And Scott goes out of bounds at the 1 yard line. The tight end, Scott, number 46.
What a great call by Lynn Amendee. George McIntyre, Lynn Amadeezy, Vanderbilt offensive coordinator. Off the veer fake, the tight end, Chuck Scott, blocked down, then delayed, came across the middle as the linebackers cleared out of the way. He was wide open, went down to the one-yard line, almost scored.
The Commodores driving now for the touchdown that put them out in front of the football game. Edwards is the tailback in this set. Stevenson now is the left set. Stevenson. Touchdown. Touchdown, Vanderbilt. A marker on the play. There is a marker. Offsides against Tennessee decline. The touchdown stands. Conversion attempt coming. That was the first touchdown for Stevenson for this season. And it puts Vanderbilt out in front 23-20 with a conversion attempt coming. Ricky Anderson will attempt it. John Patton will hold it. Patton puts it down. Anderson boots it up and it's good. So now Vanderbilt leads by 4 points, and that could be a very big point they booted just there.
I think I understand why this Vanderbilt-Tennessee game does not depend on any records, anything going into it. Look at the surge here by the Vanderbilt offensive line. Rob Monaco, Will Wolford, Jim Drayle, the center. That's the reason that play got over. Look at the surge. Look at the surge by Monaco out there in your replay here. He's done it. He's back in the end zone. He's so far there. That's why that play got in there. Great play by Vanderbilt.
1 minute, 37 seconds remaining in the third quarter. And now Vanderbilt will kick it off to Tennessee. George McIntyre, the head coach. The Vanderbilt quarterback, Kurt Page, is 16 for 26. 217 yards, one touchdown and one interception. Ricky Anderson will kick it out. Randall Morris is dropping back deep to field it for Tennessee, and they're going to spot him in the middle. Tennessee has had a very excellent kickoff return team this year.
I could try to forecast and say it's just about time for them to break one, but you never know.
All right, the signal from the referee. Anderson's kick. Randall Morris chases it over. One hop and across the end line. Touchback, first and 10 at the 20-yard line. So now the Volunteers start 80 yards away from the Commodore goal line. That last play was 65 yards and 9 plays, took 4:09. Friend of yours.
I don't know who all these characters are, but they wear this to get a ticket into the game, a free ticket into the game.
World's Fair was last year in this area.
That's the way I'm going to have to get in a few games.
Alan Cocco brings him up now. You see the last drive. Stevenson scored it on a one-yard run. Anderson kicked the point. Jones. He got out to the 22-yard line. It'll be second down and 8 at the 22. Coleman it was. I beg your pardon.
No reason for Tennessee to be conservative.
Now Coleman is hopping off, and Jones is coming back in. Chuck Coleman, who has been injured a good part of this year, is a senior from Louisville, Kentucky. He is coming off there.
You're Foy High School.
How do you know that?
Just study.
Donnie Jones, the tailback. Cockrell goes to screen right. Feeding is ducking. Duncan trying to get to the 30 for the first and 10. Did not quite make it. He missed by about a yard. Sykes made the stop. It's at the 29-yard line. Third down and a yard to play, yard to go. There you see the clock indicating the time remaining, and it's running. That's time remaining in the third quarter. Vanderbilt leading in the game by a score of 24-20. Tennessee has called a timeout with 24 seconds on the clock in the third quarter.
And that timeout might hurt them if we get a little later in the game. Remember it, fans, that timeout could hurt.
Could indeed. Came at a very inopportune time. Remember, on CBS Sports, you'll see all sorts of postseason football excitement on December 24th, the Sun Bowl at El Paso, Texas, the Alabama Crimson Tide against Southern Methodist. And then on December 25th, 46th annual Blue Gray game from Montgomery, Alabama, starting at 12:30 Eastern Time.
Crimson Bowl.
The Peach Bowl at Atlanta, Georgia. North Carolina versus Florida State, 3 p.m. Eastern Time, December 30th.
Dick Crum, Bobby Bell.
Cotton Bowl, Dallas, Texas, Texas versus Georgia, 1:30 Eastern Time, January 2nd.
That should be a great football game. I saw Georgia and Auburn play. I've seen Texas play. Two good defensive football teams. It's going to be a head knocker.
Texas fans, of course, hoping that Nebraska gets knocked off, which would possibly catapult Texas up there to the number one ranking.
Make the Longhorns number one.
East-West Shrine game in Palo Alto, California is on January 7th at 1:30 Eastern Time. You'll see all of those on CBS Sports. Right here,
Sports.
A battle between Vanderbilt and Tennessee. Vandy leading 24-20. Tennessee with the ball. Third down and a yard to go. And a power eye alignment. Give it to the fullback. I think he got it. It was Henderson carrying, and I think he got it. All he had to do was just get to the strike. And he did. First and 10 at the 30. Wade and Jordan made the tackle.
Power play, just a straight power play. Mike Furness. Kurt Singer, Glenn Steno, Tennessee's offensive line coming off. The fullback, though, had to make it with a last-second surge, second effort. Good play.
Duncan and Taylor doubled on the left side. Cockrell has the ball. Duncan. And Duncan has got it. At the 20, it's incomplete. I beg your pardon. Did not hang on. Made the diving attempt. Sykes was covering along with Coleman. Time has run out in this period on the incompleted pass to Duncan. And it is still Vandy 24, Tennessee 20 at the end of three quarters. The wind and the rain and the snow and the dark. And we're delighted to have him here this afternoon. Scott?
This is a beautiful flower arrangement from all the people of CBS who think so much and love you so much. Beautiful flower arrangement. Thanks to all of them. And you know how much we think about you.
I really appreciate it, and I tell you, I'm going to need some help getting it downstairs.
We'll get some help for you. Reggie White.
Here we go with the fourth quarter. Second down, 10 yards to go. Oh, my, oh, my. Coleman made a move on that ball. It's an incompleted pass intended for Johnny Jones. But Leonard Coleman on the corner made a move and might have taken it all the way in.
Leonard Coleman is too good a football player not to make an assertive play. Today, he did that. Look at him, almost tipping the ball up in the air. He's an excellent cornerback, making it right there.
That makes it a third down and 10 yards to go. Tennessee at their own 30-yard line. Trailing by 4 points in the game.
Big play for Tennessee here.
Cockrell, the quarterback, he has been all day. Jones. Johnny Jones, and he is gone for a touchdown. 70 yards for Johnny Jones, who piles up the rushing yardage. Tennessee out in front by a score of 26-24. Conversion attempt coming for Fouad Ravey. This is an official's timeout until it can get the debris off the field.
This is pandemonium.
This is Tennessee and Vanderbilt. The officials call the time until they can get the debris off the field. Fouad Ravey will attempt.
You knew it had to happen. Here's Tennessee's play, the counter option. Johnny Jones taking it 70 yards, but the real key to this play was the setup blocking by the Tennessee blockers who got downfield into the Vanderbilt secondary.
Ravey is with a conversion. conversion. It's good. So it is Tennessee 27, Vanderbilt 24. Johnny Jones has carried 22 times, 225 yards, and two touchdowns. Approaching 234. Gervais will do the booting, and Clay Parker and Thon Anderson have dropped back to receive it for Vanderbilt. The Commodores want that football once again. We have a world of football time left in this game. It is, of course, completely dark. The lights are on here at Neyland Stadium in Knoxville, Tennessee. Crowd of some 93,000 on hand today.
I think General Leyland and Red Sanders would not like this high-scoring affair, but we enjoy it being close.
Bob Neyland and Red Sanders like games that ended 6-0. Ruad Gervais, number four. Will not be run out. Parker just lets it stay there. Touchback, first and 10 at the 20. Now, once again, let's go to New York and to Brent Musburger.
Lindsey, it's third and 10 for Oklahoma, trailing by 7. Danny Bradley pulls out. Great defensive work here. Burke deflects the ball. Nebraska has possession. We've got about 12 minutes to go. And Norman, back to Lindsey.
All right, Brandon, right here. Tennessee is leading Vanderbilt 27-24. Jones is 9 yards away from his own single game rushing record of 234 against Rutgers earlier this year.
Vanderbilt shifting into the spread.
Kurt Page, the Vandy quarterback, completes it. And it's the first down. Taken by Keith Edwards.
This is the same counter option that Tennessee ran against Alabama in that 41-35 thing in Birmingham. That was a touchdown for them. They do it again. This time, Johnny Jones getting into the secondary. But the big key was Tennessee had three people downfield. There you see Tennessee blockers downfield shielding, if not hitting, the Vanderbilt defensive people. Johnny Jones taking it to length.
First and 10 for the Commodores of Vanderbilt at their own 30-yard line. Leave this one on the ground. Stevenson took it, Louis Stevenson, for about 2 yards out to the 32, where it'll be second down and 8 yards to go. Mark Studaway made the Tennessee tackle. There's Johnny Jones getting a little breather. Well deserved, and what a day he's had here.
225 yards. That's more than I gained in my entire career.
Kelly's in a wide left. Bullen in a wide left. And a draw play to Edwards. And he loses a yard to the 31-yard line as McKenzie, Reggie McKenzie, made the tackle. It'll be third down and 9 for Vandy at the 31.
Not much said about Reggie McKenzie from Knoxville here, but he's an agile linebacker who had a good game.
Tennessee now gets two more deep backs into the ball game. A couple of linebackers coming off. Kurt Page, the quarterback. Pulling in motion back to the inside. Pass is completed up across the 40-yard line. That'll be enough for another Vanderbilt first down. Taken by Buller.
Vanderbilt's not concerned here. They've got the passing game. They know they can move the ball. Now, Tennessee's coming with 5 defensive backs here, trying a prevent-type thing. But the key to that, the receiver found a spot between the linebackers in front of the deeper defensive backs, hooked up, made the catch.
McKenzie and Studaway made the last stop. Beg your pardon, it was not a first down in the last play. It is 3rd and 2. Started from the 32-yard line. Rolling his page, he can pick it up, and he's going to. Head for the sideline, goes out at the 50-yard line. 1st and 10 for the Commodores at the 50-yard line. Xander ran him out.
Once again, Vanderbilt employing the rolling pocket. Kurt Page acting like he's going back to drop back straight. This time coming out, both receivers covered well downfield, knowing they only needed a few yards for the first down, tucked it up, made the sidelines, made the key first down. This is excellent call by the Vanderbilt offensive people, Lynn Amendy. They know Reggie White is going to give Kirk Page trouble, and back there in the backfield, good pass rush. Get him out of there, get him some time.
They've got Kelly and Bullen in the far right now for Kirk Page, number 12 from Nashville, Tennessee. Bullen in motion all the way across, long run. Edwards carrying. Penalty marker on the play. Mark Studaway made the hit. That's Kurt Page, the Vandy quarterback. So that will be a 5-yard penalty against Vanderbilt. Tennessee is being questioned about the option, whether they want it or whether they want to decline it and have the down count. Johnny Majors is very interested in this.
He'll make that decision, I believe, even though he's not on the field.
They're having it fully explained.
Him letting all the assistants know he'll make that decision also.
Very true.
Illegal use of hands. Offense, repeat first down.
Okay. We repeat the first down and make it first and 15. Father's back there at the 45-yard line of Vanderbilt. Bullen in motion all the way outside, far right. Kirk Page with the ball. Hits it up long to Kelly down the right, left sideline. Incomplete. Second down and 15 yards to go at the 45-yard line. Harry Brown covering defensively on the corner for Tennessee.
Kurt Page airing it up to Joe Kelly, their speedster, junior college transfer, Orange, California. There you see Page's stats, 17-28, 224.
It was a disappointing season all year long for Vanderbilt, primarily because of the rash of injuries last year. He had a great season and went to a bowl game. Appeared in the Hall of Fame Bowl in Birmingham, Alabama. Kurt Page. Down to the 46-yard line. Not nearly enough for the first down.
Pass complete.
Stevenson was the receiver.
I like Vanderbilt's approach right here. They know Reggie White is going to be after them. They don't want to hold the ball very long. They want to get the backs out of the backfield, zot it to them right quick, get a part of what they needed back. Don't let Reggie get on Kurt.
Third and 7 at the 46-yard line. Roach is in the far right. Page with the ball. Incomplete. Down at the 25-yard line. Intended for Fuller. Covering was Vince Clark.
Rolling pocket again. Page coming back, going to his right. This to get away from the rush. You see Reggie White there at the nose tackle position being doubled by two Vanderbilt defensive or offensive linemen. Now Page threw the ball very well here. He did get his shoulders upfield just enough, so it might have sailed on him a little bit. And that's what happens when you don't get your shoulders upfield.
Go Commodore, she says. Anderson's back to do the punting. Benton is deep. Benton's called for the fair catch and then just let it go. And it's being down around the 3-yard line. And so Tennessee will start deep in their own end zone. Patton did the last kick.
Vanderbilt punter Patton here hitting a perfect punt. It's a Jack Nicklaus 9-iron. Watch the ball. Hits inside the 1-yard line, takes a backward spin. Looks like Nicklaus at the Masters on number 6 backing that thing up.
Well, it has backed the Volunteers up, and they start at their own 3-yard line. Tennessee leading 27-23, a 3-point differential. 10 minutes, 56 seconds left to play in this game. Mark. Lenny Taylor, far to the right side. Give it to Jones, and he gets out there across to 5 to the 6-yard line. 3 yards on the play. Second and seven. We said earlier now that against Rutgers this year, Jones set the new Tennessee all-time single-game rushing record with 234. He's approaching breaking his own rushing record. Earlier today, in case you joined us along the way, he passed the 1,000 mark for a career. First Tennessee running back ever to do that. Cockrell completes it out in the left flat. All the way up to the 15-yard line to Brown. Darren Brown. That'll be a first down. Leonard Coleman was the defender over there.
Tennessee not being conservative, coming out and throwing the little quick hitch pass. Not a dangerous pass, but enough to get the first down. I know why you live in Knoxville now, Mr. Nelson.
Of course. First and 10 at the 15-yard line. Jones, and he gets nothing on that one. Stopped at the 15-yard line. It was Steve McCoy and Tom Moore defensively for Vanderbilt. Second down, 10 yards to go at the 15 for Tennessee.
Not much been said today about the Vanderbilt defenders, but Steve McCoy here coming out with a big play, playing off the block, sealing up the hole, keeping the runner from making any ground whatsoever.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Tennessee at their own 15, leading by 3 points in the game. Cockrell, under the left flat.
Watch out.
And it's Clyde Duncan. Clyde Duncan stretching it out, and there he goes. 85 yards for a touchdown. Touchdown of the year, an 85-yard. The previous long was 80. Reveille starts the conversion. It's good. Fouad Reveille for the conversion. So that it is now Tennessee 34 and Vanderbilt 24. 10-point differential.
You heard me say earlier in the game that Tennessee was going to get a big play, a big pass off the flanker quick screen. Alan Cockrell faking right to hold the linebackers, slips it out to Clyde Duncan. Look at the block out there. Kurt Singer getting out in front of Duncan. That's what initially threw him, and look at the convoy of blockers he has here. A quick screen goes 85 yards to Clyde Duncan. Great play.
Clyde Duncan, a senior from Oxon Hill, Maryland, with his sixth touchdown of this year. Tennessee now leads by 10 in the fourth quarter. Alan Cockrell now has completed 15 of 25 in the air, 266 yards, two touchdowns, and one interception.
Oh, hey, there's old Smokey. One time, the cheerleaders let him run at me. I kicked at him. The Tennessee student body started giving me a lot of heck about it. Coach Bryant came out of the tunnel and said, Scott, we got enough trouble out here without trying to kick their ball.
He's right.
Old Smokey.
Fouad Reveille will kick it off. Clay Parker and Don Anderson are deep to receive it for Vanderbilt.
And Vanderbilt's got trouble here.
Parker's side. Touchback. First and 10 at the 20-yard line. Rushing in the ball game. Tennessee 260 yards, passing 266 yards. Total yards, 526.
526 yards. There is no way General Bob Levin will like that.
Here's the scoring drive. Four plays, 97 yards. Time, 148. An 85-yard pass will take care of a lot of that.
I wouldn't call it a drive. I call it a sprint.
A spurt. First and 10 to the 20-yard line. Great Page, the Vanderbilt quarterback. Retreating to put it up. And it does, and completes it. Out across the 30. That's the first down to Edwards. First and 10 at the 33-yard line.
9 minutes and 3 seconds left in the football game. 34-24, Tennessee, but no problem, no reason for Vanderbilt to panic. They're going to do exactly what they've been doing. Come back, hit the little stop routes, the halfback moving routes. This particular route is a halfback option route. He goes out, comes off the weak linebacker to the outside. Page hits it perfectly.
Dale Jones made the tackle. Page over the middle and completes this one. Out across the 40-yard line. This time to Chuck Scott. Carl Zander made the tackle. Second down and 3 yards to go at the 40. Stevenson moves over a stride, lone setback. Kirk Page over the head of Edwards on the sideline. Third and 3. Jones was covering Dale Jones. Edwards, number 5.
Page missed Chuck Scott that time on the right-hand side, who was wide open. Watch, they may go back to him this time. Scott today, 3 catches for 46 yards. That may mount up here in the fourth quarter as they begin to find him a lot more, though.
Big play coming here for Vanderbilt. They trailed by 10 points in the game in the fourth quarter. They're on a 3rd down and 3. Stevenson moves over the side. Edwards is the other setback. Page. Turned it outside. Not enough for the first down. Penalty marker is thrown. Scott took the ball. And the defender was Tommy Sims. About 2 yards short of first down yardage, but there is a penalty here.
Kirk Page got rid of the ball under tremendous pressure.
Defense.
Face mask, defense, Tennessee. That will give Vanderbilt a first down. It was Sims.
Reggie White, Tennessee coaches told me he would line up as the nose tackle in this game in their dime defense prevent coverage. That time, he bull rushes right through the guard and the center.
Grabbing a face mask, defense, first down.
Makes it a first down and 10 for Vandy. At their 46-yard line. Back it off into an I formation. Kirk Page quarterbacking. Edwards got it up to the 49-yard line. Picked up 3 on the play. That'll make it 2nd down and 7. White and Holt made the tackle for Tennessee. Another penalty marker. Tennessee's being consulted.
Holding offense.
Penalty against Vanderbilt. So now let's go to New York for an update with Brent Musburger. Won't go away if you won't.
We're not going anywhere, Brent.
We'd like to hear from you.
Keep feeding them to us, Brent.
8 minutes, 2 seconds left to play in this game. First down and 20 yards to go. Ball is on the 37. Spread out there for Kirk Page. Completed, short, up to the 43-yard line. Stevenson was the receiver, and Fisher made the hit. I think I heard the collision all the way up here.
Tennessee was using their dime prevent. Dime prevent being double nickel. It's 6 defensive backs with Reggie White moved over the center to get a bull rush, as we just saw a couple of plays before. This time Page reads it. Back sets down perfectly in between the defenders, but he takes a shot, a lot of people on him. A reason to play prevent, not to stop the pass as much as someone be there when he catches it.
2nd and 14. Pump one time, wanted to run, and was sacked at the 39-yard line for a loss of 4 yards, which will make it 3rd and 18. Dale Jones got to him.
That time what happened in the secondary, a Vanderbilt receiver tripped over a Tennessee defender. They ran together. Page was about to deliver the ball. He was anticipating the receiver to going to be open. Not the one you see up short in your screen, but one deeper, anticipating him to be open. They tripped over each other. Nobody was open. He had to eat it.
The official's holding him up just for the moment. Now he's marking the ball ready for play. Third and long here for Vanderbilt. 6.5 minutes left in the game.
Long for Vanderbilt is not like long for anybody else.
I understand. They can move in the air. Page intercepts it back at the 48-yard line. And it's taken by Benton, and he's on his way. Penalty marker back upfield. Benton returned it, fumbled it at the 5-yard line. Penalty marker back at the 45-yard line. So we have a lot of administration to take care of. We'll get some word here from the referee.
Clipping.
Clipping on the run back, so Tennessee will retain possession, but it'll be back downfield.
This time, Kurt Page went back. He's looking out to his right. He dogged his receiver a little bit too much. He didn't deliver the ball out and away as you should throw a square out and away and bring the man back. He threw it short and low behind him. There's your dime back, the sixth man in the Tennessee prevent coverage, Charlie Benton picking it off.
But the clipping allows them to retain possession, but they get it at their own 39-yard line, first and 10.
Clipping on the run back, first down.
So the dime back comes through for Tennessee in a real clutch situation.
Benton has been a busy man today. After McGee went out with the first half entry, he's been used on the punt return. Here's the final, Nebraska 28, Oklahoma 21. Well, the Sooners certainly gave them a battle all afternoon long and a lot of thrills, but Nebraska remains the number one rated football team in the country.
Everything it was supposed to be.
They've had a great, great season. Tennessee 34, Vanderbilt 24. 6 minutes, 1 second left to play in the game. Johnny Jones of Tennessee has carried 24 times for 228 yards. He is 6 yards short of the single game record that he set against Rutgers earlier this year. Already he has become the only 1,000-yard rusher in Tennessee football history. 1,000 yards in a single season. There he goes. Johnny Jones moves it up there to the 43-yard line.
This is an anything-can-happen situation. Vanderbilt has to line up and do some things defensively to force Tennessee to have bad plays, fumble, bust assignments. But when that happens, sometimes those guys can slip through there and make it all the way.
Here's a final score. Arizona 17, Arizona State 15. What a battle. That's final. Jones got 4 yards that last time. He needs 2 now to get to the new single-game rushing record, and that's Jones. And he got more than 2. So he just sets now. Every time he gains a yard, he sets a new single-game rushing record for Tennessee. Spotted up there near the 49-yard line. Steve Wade made the tackle. Gained a 6 yards on the last play.
Steve Wade, Chattanooga Tyner High School. Home of good friend Roy Exum there. Chattanooga paper.
About a half a yard short of the first down, third down coming up. Henderson's the fullback. Henderson got the first down. He just went flying through the air and he got it. 245 pounds in full flight.
He had the flaps up. He was sailing.
Windham and Coleman made the tackle.
This is what it takes. You've got to call on the big man when it's there to be needed. Sam Henderson using drive, power, getting up, making the first down. Sometimes a back has to be his own blocking.
Tennessee leading in the game 34 to 24, 10-point margin with 4.5 minutes left to play. Game played before some 93,000 at Neyland Stadium in Knoxville here this afternoon and early evening. Taylor in motion all the way across. Johnny Jones, more yardage, and every time he gains a yard, it's a new record, down to the 40-yard line. Sykes and Jordan made the tackle for Vanderbilt.
Sprint draw behind Steve Knight and Bill Mayo. Good play.
We're getting an official time to bring out the chain to see if they picked up the first down. Johnny Jones' new single-game rushing record is being announced to the crowd. And there's the reaction. That is a lot of rushing yardage in one afternoon football game.
What a day for him.
It was a first down, as you saw, at the 40-yard line. Alan Cockrell bringing him up. Cockrell's had a good day today. Taylor in motion all the way across. Johnny Jones. And now let's go to Brent Musburger once again in New York. Thanks for keeping us up to date on an exciting football game all afternoon long. What a lulu. And we've got one here.
Great group of football games today. Nebraska, Oklahoma, Arizona, Arizona State, and this one.
Second down, 8 yards to go at the 38. Tennessee in Vanderbilt territory. Johnny Jones popped by the Vandy defense. It was Steve Wade who got turned for a loss on the play. Back to the 41-yard line.
Vanderbilt doing a lot of stunning linebacker blitzing here, trying to do anything to stop Tennessee to get a turnover.
Third down, 11 yards to go. Clock is running. 2 minutes, 35 seconds left to play. Johnny Jones on the draw from Cockrell. Only to the 39. Now, once again, let's get updated on Arizona, Arizona State with Brent Musburger in New York.
Lindsey, this one was the Battle of the Zendejas, and Max Zendejas of Arizona, the younger brother, beat Luis. Luis had put Arizona State ahead, then Max won it 17-15 for Arizona. Some afternoon. Let's go back to Lindsey.
That's what we said, Brent. Some afternoon.
Two minutes,
16 seconds left here. Tennessee leading Vandy 34-24. Tennessee, of course, wanting to close out the season, the regular season, with a win and head on to the Citrus Bowl, where they'll be playing the University of Maryland. Next Saturday, a college football basketball doubleheader at noon Eastern time. Florida State, led by their outstanding running back, Greg Allen, meeting interstate rival Florida. Then at 4 p.m. Eastern, one of college basketball's great rivalries will be renewed as Bobby Knight's Indiana Hoosiers meet the powerful Kentucky Wildcats. It's all next Saturday on CBS Sports. Jimmy Colquitt's in to punt. Only punted once for 57 yards. Rick Risser's back deep for Vandy. Colquitt waiting for the snap. Whistler lets it go. And it is a touchback. It is a touchback. It'll be put in play first and 10 at the 20-yard line. Tennessee trying to scramble to down it down there along the goal line, but could not get to it. So now the Commodores take over, trailing by 10 points, and have the ball at their own 20-yard line with 2 minutes, 5 seconds left to play in this game. So now it's Kurt Page. You'll see what he can do about moving the Commodores upfield. He's got to do it comparatively in a hurry. Bill Roach out to a wide left.
Crowd chanting, Reggie, Reggie.
And it's complete. Out across the 30-yard line to Edwards, and Keith Edwards has run out of bounds after he picked up 10 yards. That'll be a first down. Fisher made the tackle. Reggie White has had a great season here at the University of Tennessee, and as we mentioned before, he is one of the four finalists for the Lombardi Trophy. Outstanding lineman in the country, and he's had a great, great year.
Ordained Baptist minister, fine young man.
Kurt Page, Vandy quarterback. Well, he put it up very long to Roach. Incomplete. Second and 10 at the 30-yard line. Tennessee leading 34-24.
Vandy will, of course, try to complete passes near the sidelines to save time, get the completion, get out of bounds.
A victory would give Tennessee a record of 8 wins and 3 losses, their best record in 11 years.
Johnny Majors putting two good years back-to-back here at Tennessee. He's got this program on the rise.
Page for the pass is complete to Edwards, and he goes out of bounds at the 39-yard line. Fisher bounced him out. Short of first down yardage. .147 on the clock. Time remaining to be played. That's Roach going to a wide right. Fuller coming to a wide left. Edwards moves up to a wing right. Edwards in motion. He's the trailer and he's got the ball. He's also got the first down, I believe. Terry Brown on the corner made the tackle.
Vanderbilt needs more than that, though. No time for that.
First and 10 on the 42-yard line. 1:41 on the clock. The Commodores trail by 10. And it's complete across the 45. On up to the 47-yard line. Kurt Page unleashing that one. Stevenson gathered it in.
Tennessee content to give Vandy the short option pass to the backside of the backfield, but don't want to give up that long one.
Second down and 5 yards to go. A loss would give Vanderbilt a season's conference record in the Southeastern Conference of no wins and 6 losses. That's Edwards. Gets across to the 40-yard line. First and 10 for Vandy.
Still, anything can happen, Lindsey. Anything can happen. We were behind Tennessee one time, 10-3. A little over 2 minutes to go. Wound up losing 10-9, but had a chance to win the game after recovering an onside kick. Anything can happen here.
Vanderbilt has called a timeout with 1:03 remaining to be played in this game. Vanderbilt is out of timeouts now. They have no more. They have the ball first and 10 at the Tennessee 40, and Tennessee's leading in the game by a score of 34-24. The clock starts on the snap with 1:03 left to play in this game. Played in beautiful weather here in Knoxville, Tennessee. Triple-A players of the game, Keith Edwards for Vanderbilt, rushed 10 times for 51 yards, caught 8 passes for 81 yards. Johnny Jones rushed for 248 for Tennessee, 7th on the all-time rushing in a single game in the SEC. A check in the amount of $1,000 will be donated by Chevrolet to each school's general scholarship fund to further assist qualified students. Page throwing. And the deflection is taken inside the 15-yard line. Capabiana gathered it in on the deflection. So it'll be a first down and 10 yards to go at the 14.
Heads up play by Capabiana there. Page audibling at the line.
Page now. Standing and looking and throwing back and inside the 10-yard line and complete at the 8 to Stevenson. Clock is running with 33 seconds left to play in the game. Tennessee 34, Vanderbilt 24. No huddle play. Vandy's ready to go. Second down and 4 yards to go. Thrown out of bounds to stop the clock. They spot it again on the 8-yard line. Third down and 4 yards to go.
That inbounds completion down to the 8. May have hurt Vanderbilt more than it helped there, Lindsey. Some 15 to 16 seconds got off the clock before they could line up and throw the ball out of bounds.
Clock now will start on the snap with 22 seconds remaining. Johnny Majors, a busy head coach along the sideline. He's had a good season. Page. Edwards can't hang on. Onto the fingertips of Edwards. He could not control it. So it'll be fourth down and 4 yards to go. Duncan was covering over there defensively.
Vanderbilt trying a so-called pick flood zone play there. The two wide receivers going down and trying to semi-pick, if you want to call it that. That's not a legal thing to do. Semi-pick Tennessee defensive backs. Edwards coming out of the backfield, free and clear, but Page throwing it just a little high.
That's George McIntyre, the Vanderbilt Commodore.
One class gentleman there.
Yes, he is. 18 seconds on the clock. There's Page with the ball, fourth down. Throws it into the end zone, and it is incomplete. That's Davis covering defensively, batting it down. So the ball goes over on downs. Tennessee gets the ball, and then Vandy will be unable to stop the clock because they're out of timeouts. 12 seconds remain to be played.
And that's the football game. It was a good one.
For all intents and purposes, it certainly is, because all Tennessee has to do is snap the ball, and that will do it. Tennessee is leading 34 to 24.
Station break, cars.
Alan Cockrell has quarterback all day long. And he simply hits the deck, puts that knee down, and now that will end the ball game. There will be no further snaps. And the ball game will be over in 2 seconds.
Fine effort by both football teams. Nobody has anything to be ashamed of. Enjoyed working with you, Lindsey. Welcome home.
Thank you kindly, Scott. Enjoyed seeing you. Final score, Tennessee 34, Vanderbilt 24. It's an exclusive presentation of CBS Sports. We'll return with more coverage after this word from your local station.